Because right now we're playing Clock Tower 1. We finished the game as Helen with ending. We got endings B, C, and E. Let's play as Jennifer now that I actually know how to play as Jennifer. Allow me to show you how weird it is to select Jennifer. You might think, oh, you just do like a title screen or like a character select somewhere. Nope. Nope, not at all. Also, this is not highly Googleable because there are two games named Clock Tower. And on top of that, this seems to be the less popular one, so usually you find info about the Super Nintendo one, which also was on PS1, which does not make things easier to Google. It's very silly.
Professor Bart. Professor Bart.
Let me know if the audio is okay or not.
What are you doing, Professor? You mustn't hypnotize her like this. She's not ready to remember the murders yet.
Helen, the Clock Tower murders are fascinating research material for me. I must know the truth of what happened.
She can't take any more of this today, Professor. I'm taking her home.
All right. But remember one thing, Helen. You may be her guardian, but you are also my assistant.
Yes, Professor.
But she's also a teacher. I don't... Never, man. All right. I believe we need to inspect both the scissors and the table. So we've done the intro like three times. No, we've done it twice now. A pair of scissors on the desk. They're a replica of the scissors used by the murderer in the Clock Tower case. These are like the weapon he used to slash up his victims. I do kind of... You know, again... This game feel okay, I want to say this, I should have said this while I was in the credits of the last playthrough here, but this game, the first one feels like there's obviously a lot of homage to like giallo, like Italian giallo films. Oh, sorry, the mass murder of over 10 victims in this case. How intriguing. Yo, Raina! Jennifer Simpson. Ah, I did get the information of her future profiling materials. Raina, you just missed the weed game, sorry. But also, welcome on in. Maybe I should have just played as Jennifer. My laboratory. Lately, I've been doing mostly criminal psychology research. We just started this game, though. So maybe we'd stolen by a bud tender and refuse to refund me. That sucks. The staff's still here. Okay, there's a couple things we need to inspect in this room, and I don't remember what all of them are. Sick new game. Hell yeah. Statue. It is cold. One of the items found at the scene of the Clock Tower murders. Yeah, we literally started this like playthrough like a minute or two ago, so you've missed almost nothing. We've already played through as the other character, but we're playing through as a different character this time, so it should be somewhat different. It'd be a good idea to get an expert opinion on this. Okay, there's something else to click on over here. There was something I had to click on last time. Oh, it was a computer. That's what it was. No more dogging? Dogging's here. Oh, I don't know if the dog will be here. That's right, you were here for the other playthrough last time. Dogging is all caps, though. Professor, Helen left a... Wait, is it not here? Hold on a second. It's right there. Yeah, there you go. Sorry for the window sound. Professor, Helen left a few minutes ago, and she looked really angry. You know, Helen and Jennifer are really beginning to look like sisters, aren't they? I'm rereading all the stuff in the prologue just for the sake of this recording, I guess, more than anything. I guess this is what happens when you live together. People say that about pets. I don't know if that's even fair to say, though, honestly. One mustn't let their personal feelings get in the way. Jennifer is nothing more than another research student subject. Yes, you're right. I want to see if we can tell that guy to get a passport or something. Scissorman's rubber mask. A kind sold in cheap novelty shops and seems to be fairly popular. People can certainly buy stupid things. Professor, a newspaper reporter is here. Did you have an appointment for the interview? It's about the Clock Tower murders, isn't it? Ah. I guess they want to sensationalize this Scissor Man who really doesn't even exist? Scissorman, it'd be cool if you were real. Huh? They're, just a joke. Shouldn't keep the reporter waiting too long. We gotta read this thing or else it won't let us out of the fucking room. Harris's desk. Clipped out articles of this clock tower story are scattered about. Seems Harris has gone somewhere. Yeah, so like I mentioned, there are two different players you can play as in this game. It makes, there's like not a tutorial or any, maybe in the manual it tells you this, I don't fucking know. But here's how you choose which character you play as. You either ignore this guy, or you talk to him once, or you talk to him twice, and ignoring him and talking to him once are the same thing. A newspaper reporter was looking for you on the first floor. Talking to him twice lets you play as Jennifer. Oh, thank you. Is Jennifer... She's already gone home. Was there something... hints in the game tell you? Something you wanted? No. I don't know. That's still... That is, I like this game a lot, don't get me wrong. But that is dog shit. I cannot... That is so fucking stupid. Top notch, though. That's for sure. But then... dot, dot, dot. I genuinely like this game a lot. So please don't let me, like, sound like I'm shitting on this game, but that individual one thing is really dumb. I actually literally can't even figure out how to read the hints that you find in the game. But that's more of a me problem, but... Like, I assume those are hints you find after the fact, right? Because this is, like, that's the first thing. The first hint you find, which is hint number one, is after this anyway, isn't it? Like, while you're wandering around this area as one of the other characters? Unless there's a hint before hint number one, I don't know if they're in order or not. Oh, hey, Professor. I'm the one who called you from Oslo Weekly News. My name is Nolan Campbell. And this is Tim, my cameraman. It's a pleasure. I'm a bit busy. Please keep it brief. Also, what's up, Purple Goida? You been able to figure out who the murderer... Yeah. That is all I'm saying. It's like that thing individually and like a couple other things are like gotcha moments. Like, oh, you said no to the policeman and that just means like, don't tell him to go find the statue so no one will now. but it's totally fine. Yeah, but it is hint one. Gotcha. But I'm pretty sure you get that in this building after the prologue, which is okay. You know, you play through as one character and then come back to it, but I don't even know how to read those, which is, again, probably more of a me problem, but I don't know. You ever figure out who the murderer is? I can't say anything for sure yet, because the victim's testimony lacks credibility. Oh, you mean the victim that's testifying? That'd be Jennifer Simpson, wouldn't it? So, okay, this is just more of a tangent. Yes, but what about her? Oh, nothing really, just that we saw her. This is my, like, tinfoil hat conspiracy slash something that anybody that knows anything about this game could probably easily solve. The fact that you can't quickly click through things makes me think that maybe the Japanese version has more voice acting than the English version, but I don't know. That's just a guess. I could be totally fucking wrong. I don't know. Or it's just that, like, they sometimes there is voice acting, it's the same system or whatever, so, like... Since we run into her, we asked her for an interview, but she refused. You just said her testimony lacked credibility. I know what you're gonna say. That monster she was talking about, the Scissorman. Whether he really exists or not. That's right. That's what our readers want to know. Because the existence of the Scissorman has become a symbol of terror among us. Among youngsters. Yes, that's because trashy gossip magazines like yours have sensationalized the whole thing. Ouch, that hurts. Not much I can say there, is there? Dude. Fuck. Dude, going back to positive stuff, I fucking love, like, well, maybe Tim is, like, whatever, he's just here. But, like, Nolan and I forgot this guy's name. They're both great. I wish I got the best ending so I could figure out what this guy's involvement was. Like, he clearly is something related to all the stuff going on, because he killed us in the first ending I got. Barton, that's his name. Well, let's start from the conclusion. It's a fact that there was a murderer who used a giant pair of scissors as his murder weapon. Such a thing I don't mind. Oh yeah, that's totally fine. Like, I don't even care that it splits off like that, but I could see some people being maybe upset by that. I'm dealing with some odd screwball. But what about what she said? She was scared. It does not have more voice acting than the Japanese version? Good to know. I see, but... Okay, that's it. Interview's over. There's something I must be attending to. Ah, well, okay. I understand. Going back to her... Thank you very much. Sorry, I couldn't be as much help as you'd hoped. This is kind of a bad stream game, because I can't talk. The game is, like, mostly text. I had to get back to the lab, and a lot of it is also time-sensitive. Expecting another survivor of the Clock Tower murders. He's supposed to be a young boy about 10 years old. There's probably a lot less scrolling in the Japanese version. Really enough, the voices are in English with different takes on delivery. Interesting. That's actually really cool. I bet the text is still in Japanese, though. Because I was just talking about this earlier, like, I could buy this for PS1, but it's like $200. I don't really want to spend that much money on this game. I like it, but not that much. But the Japanese version is pretty cheap, and I have a Japanese PS2, which should play Japanese PS1 games. So whenever it's voice acted, I'd be able to understand it, but probably not for the majority of the game, though. Sound better, in a way. Japanese penis. I don't know what that means. That's what it sound. That's what that. Reina's high as shit. Okay. Chad, help me out. No. Don't load. Oh god. Oh, a Japanese penis 2. Not a Japanese PS2. Not a Japanese penis 2. If I don't give the statue to this guy, is the statue not able to be found, or does that just mean I need to go to the library? Does anybody know? Yeah, the text is. Okay, damn it. That's fair enough and probably what I would have assumed, but, you know. I think I saved... Yeah, this save is... We can save over this. This is after Jennifer died, so it doesn't matter. We can definitely save over save one, too. It just goes to the library. Okay, cool. We're gonna do that. Thank you. Oh, that's right. I still need to get an expert opinion on the statue. Didn't mean to click that twice. I'm trying to click Harris. Not Harris, this guy. No, that is Harris. What am I saying? Professor, the boy that survived the Clock Tower murders is here. Oh, has he arrived already? Yes, he's waiting in the therapy room. Is there something I can do for you? Something I can do for you? Alright, bye. Hey, talk to him, then you examine the statue. That's how you give it to him. Oh my god. We need to decide yes or no. I guess, yeah, that's kind of fair, because this is kind of an important decision, you know? That's right, I still need to get an expert opinion on the statue. I should probably ask Professor Sullivan, the head librarian at the Metropolitan Library. Yes, but there was an old butler at the Barrows Castle mansion named Rick. They call it both. Okay, I'm not crazy here. I'll show it to him first to see if he knows anything. I'm pretty sure he lives in the suburbs. If we end up with ending E, oh well. Do not ask Harris. Alright then. Oh, Professor Sullivan at the library. Okay, it's very explicit. Cool. The library to take a look. Okay, that's it. I should probably go to the therapy room. Appreciate the help. Purple. Purple Goeta. Having trouble reading stuff. I can't imagine what would be causing me to have trouble with any of that. Thank you very much for coming. How do you do? I'm an instructor at the Granite Orphanage. I am Edward's guardian. Edward? I thought he completely lost all his memory from the shock. Does he remember his name? No, I call him Edward because not having a name to go by makes things very difficult. There. Edward, ellipses. Oh, since this is our first day, will you answer some simple questions for me? Okay, Edward? No, I want you to honestly tell me everything you remember about what happened. Yes. Well then, let's get started. I'm trying to give Barton like a 20s like gangster accent. Alright. We're gonna save over that then. I feel very confident based on what the game said to me in combination with what Chad has said to me. Also, I hope the levels are good. Please let me know if it's not. The elevator buttons were a penis. ZD, I read over your comment because everyone's talking about penis over here. Helen isn't home yet. Well, actually, it's really just Reyna, but... I skimmed over. I thought it was the same line. I think I'll go out for a while. Where shall I go? I can't go to Police Street. I'm gonna go everywhere before the campus. Metropolitan Library. Helen's mentor, Mr. Sullivan, is the head librarian. Two bottom buttons with a single button do make a penis. Fair enough. I missed it. Don't worry though, we'll get a chance to see it again because it's the first level of the game. Unless it's different for Jennifer, I don't know. Hello, Jennifer. Did you come to check out a book or something? Mr. Sullivan, you're as cute as ever. How's Helen? She's fine, but she's been busy lately. I see. Oh, by the way, I've added to my collection again. Do you want to come see? It's quite a collection of archaeological value. No, thank you. It would take a long time. Goodbye, Mr. Sullivan. Well, drop in for a visit anytime. I love the way Mr. Sullivan gets executed. That's why I wanted the book to go to the library. Sorry, not sorry. Hotel. Well, that's right. Edward is supposed to be here. Yeah. I wonder what kind of boy he is. Best death in the game. It really is. There's a lot of great ones, but that's like, it's so fucking good. I was laughing my ass off the first time I saw it. It's so good. I even like, I was like, oh, he just poke. I said it before it happened. I'm like, let me poke my head out here. I'm not gonna, you know what? I'm not gonna ruin it. Is this boy Edward? Are you by chance Jennifer? Yes. Yes, I am Jennifer. I thought so. Recognize your face from all the pictures of the paper. Oh, my name is Kay. I'm an instructor at the Granite Orphanage. The Granite Orphanage? Yes, but I began after you left. Is he? Yes, he is Edward. Say hello, Edward. That is, you're right. Hello, Edward. How do you do? Jennifer, Edward has lost his memory from the shock of what happened. Yes, I've heard. You were also involved, weren't you? Speaking with you might jog his memory. ... I was hoping you would be able to come visit Edward. Please. Yes, that would be fine. I will come as often as I can. Well, I must be going. Oh, I'm sorry for keeping you. See you again soon, Edward. Bye-bye. Let's go to the newspaper company. If I went to the newspaper office, I would just be chased by reporters. She's not wrong. Well, that just really leaves the research building, but I'm gonna go here first. University Personal Housing. I live here with Helen. Smiley face. No one would be there if I went home now, though. I will go see Helen. She should still be in her lab. It's okay. They'll all fucking forget by the time we get there. It's fine. Oh, hello, Jennifer. What's up? Oh, nothing much. I just came for a little visit. No, I talked to her more. Oh, really? I'm going to be a bit late tonight. You go ahead and eat without me. Are you busy? My hard drive crashed and I lost all my data. Gotta get it restored tonight. Oh, I see. Please leave the key in its usual place. Okay, I will. Good luck, Helen. Maybe our first level is actually different. Huh? Someone's in front of the house! Oh, that's... dot dot dot. Oh, that's just Scissor Man. She said nonchalantly. Oh, it's Nolan. This fucking guy, what does he want? This is music. You're the reporter that came to the university yesterday, aren't you? Oh yes, please call me Nolan. I've been collecting information on the clock tower case for a long time now. Even though it's a really big case, very little of the truth is understood. As a reporter, I simply can't leave it alone. Yes, the truth. And I'm interested in you, too. Excuse me? I think we are actually like a well, that's not what he's saying, though, to be fair. Hey, what do you say to having dinner with me? Gross? Yeah. Poor wording. Weird translation. I don't care what you tell me, I just want you- he is asking us out to dinner. I just want to talk to you. I hope he dies. He can. We can kill him intentionally. You asked me on a date? Well, okay. I'm hoping... That's it. Both. I am really hoping... Yes, both an interview and a date. That information was wrong. Stranger danger indeed. Alright, no, that was actually... What... That was translated appropriate... Or not appropriately, but correctly. Alright then, T. Let's go. You know... Not feeling much more confident that she's an adult. That's me alluding to earlier when I was talking about I was trying to figure out how to play as Jennifer and I found like a wiki. It's very late. That's a super different level. Someone seems to be following me. Continues to walk at the same pace. Scandinavia living. You don't know, do you? I don't know. I guess we go through the park. No, we're on tracks. I'm not really affecting anything right now. Oh, okay, I'm home. Oh.
What's wrong?
Voice acting.
Some kind of weirdo?
Okay, yeah, that's kind of what I expected. Oh, that's a security guard for... Okay, yeah, we're just in the same building, never mind. Yeah, still in here. But also immediately being chased by Scissorman. Rip. Hold on, we're about to get him good, chat. Watch this. Okay, that is what I read on the wiki. Which was making me very uncomfortable in that cutscene, but I'm like, okay, maybe they meant that's her age in the first game? No, yeah, I see. Okay, yeah. That's not the guy that died, though. You know, basically, we kill him passively. We just don't open the coffin he's in. I don't know if Jennifer's scenario is different, though. Maybe it is a little different. How do I leave? Oh, for some reason, that was a right click. I don't know why. Alright, save again. No, stop loading! For anyone that's not sure what I'm doing right now, why I can't control the menu, it's probably somewhat obvious, but I'm controlling this entirely with my mouse. So to bring up this menu, I had to left-click and right-click simultaneously. And then, like, I move the mouse up and down to move the menu. Left for shadow. Yeah, everyone's shadow. Like, as soon as you notice that, it's, like, impossible to, like, stop looking at. Everyone's shadow is, like, the game Balls 3D. Okay, so she's 14 in the first game, so it's only a year later, she's 15. Yeah, that's bad. That's bad, okay? Alright, we're gonna use the elevator for ZD's sake, because he mentioned that it looks like a penis. You're being put on trial now, ZD. Is it true? Oh, he's in there. Oh, he's fucking in there. God fucking damn it. Get in there, Jennifer. Go, go, go. Go! Where are you going? Go! Go indoor! Now! Norwegian in 90s pervs, according to the chat. Yeah. Oh, there's a key in there we need, actually. Hold on. I can hide under here. We're fine. You know, in my defense, when I played as Helen, I went in the elevator like 6 times, and every time I was in there, it's like, Scissor Man's gonna jump out at me this time. It never fucking happened. First time we go in there is Jennifer. Ha! Oh, I'm dead! Okay, yeah, see? Oh, wait, no, we're not dead, actually. That is bullshit, though. But D314, you were wrong. It's not just, oh, some hiding spots just don't work the second time you use them. It's just straight up like, yeah, sometimes he'll just be like, fuck it. Fuck it, we ball. I need the fucking key in that room. I'm kind of mad that he's being an asshole right now. I need to find the flashlight, too. Please go. Yeah, no, I think it is just entirely RNG, which is fine. Well, it's fine for scenarios like that where it doesn't kill you. I guess it's fine otherwise as well, because, I mean, you know, whatever. Like, if he kills you, just restart exactly in the room that you were just in. It's not like you'd lose a lot of progress or anything. Go, no, go in the left stall, please. Some spots are RNG. Oh yeah, we found at least one in the castle that was not RNG. Because we did it like 3 times in a row and he never, like, got us. Hello, Rose. How you doing in there? Yeah, no, I just was, straight up. But... Yeah, the cliff door. Absolutely, every single time. Chat knows. Chat saw me do that so many fucking times. Let's go! I assume that's a let's go emote based on what it looks like. I could be wrong. I'm gonna go get that key because I know I need it. I need to find the flashlight before I leave here too, because apparently that's a very important item that you need in the third act. That one is not RNG. Yeah, I figured. I feel like everything you hide in is probably RNG. Well, okay. Ones where you hit him with stuff is not RNG very clearly, but you can only use those once. I should have taken the elevator down. We will take the elevator at some point. I promise. Just to go. That guy's fucking dead. That's a dead body. Scissorman's gonna jump out at us if I inspect him for sure. Oh, that's the ladder key. We could actually just leave right now, I'm pretty sure. That's different. Okay. Well, good to know. I'm gonna go get the flashlight before we leave, though. It's your default when you're exhausted over all of the evasion spots. Yeah, that makes sense. That scared me. Oh, all the scenarios have one? That's good to know. Telephone is dead. Oh, it's different. It's all different. This guy is, like, giga dead. Fine, Scissorman, come out after this guy dies.
Excuse me.
I like that he is already, like, rotted. Like, his skin is, like, pale. Like, he's already starting to rot. I think the flashlight's in the storage room on the first floor, but we need a key for that. Maybe we don't, actually. We might be able to just go in there. Whatever, we're going in this elevator. It also may be in a different spot for Jennifer's scenario. Alright, there's the penis that Zudi was talking about. Oh yeah, there's no power. Okay. It's different. Zudi's right. Listen, as someone once said, sometimes an elevator button control is just an elevator button control. Door is locked. I'm sure Helen's laboratory is on the second floor. I do need to find this flashlight, or else. Yeah, here's the room I was looking. You fucking asshole. It's easier than Helen's? Oh, hell yeah. Well, then we'll probably... Well, that doesn't mean it's quicker, though, I guess. I mean, we have the key to the ladder. I know the ladder's at the top. We can leave. But if I need the flashlight in the third scenario, I'd rather get that before we leave this. Because the flashlight's in this area. Unless it's not for Jennifer, I guess. I'm gonna take a look around is my point, I guess. We've already finished three endings of Helen's scenario for reference. We got ending E, ending C, and ending B. Ending D for Helen, at least, kind of sounds like the let's just get the hell out of here. Oh god, what is that movie called? Event Horizon? The Event Horizon ending? Fuck this, we're leaving. Helen's ending C was kind of just like, well, you're dead now. Food crumbs, blah, 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 blah. Where was the flashlight? I'm pretty sure it was in this room, but I could actually just be wrong. I don't know. It also might not be in the same spot for Jennifer. That's entirely possible. Which, if so, I like that. What's this? I think we found it. We found hint two. Hint two. Yeah, especially in scenario 3, you have to, like, you can't go in the wrong rooms at the wrong times or else you'll just lose. I have an oil can. Oh, I bet there's a rusty hinge. Okay, I think we have everything we need to leave now. It's locked. There's a thing I can inspect over here, though, isn't there? Maybe not. Oh, well. I'm really glad I came back to this instead of just jumping into Ghost Head. Like, oh, we finished it, technically, but... It didn't feel satisfying to leave it where we had it, you know? Was it in a locker, maybe? I know the third locker is, like, one of the ones that... I almost called him Pyramid Head. Scissor Man. Several lockers for the staff. This one, maybe? That's locked, okay. Are you in here, Scissorman? Yep, he sure fucking is. Cool, dude. Please keep running. We'll go to the second floor this time. Whatever you can do to prolong playing Ghost Head. I mean, if I really wanted to prolong it, I'd just, like, skip it and go to Haunting Ground first. But I'm not gonna do that. We'll fucking play the game. Haunting Ground will be our, like, victory lap of playing a game that is at least supposedly good. I'm sure it's gonna be better than Ghost Head. I can go in here, right? God help you. Oh no. I've heard people be critical of Haunting Ground, or Haunting Grounds, plural. But, I don't know. These look really boring. I think I'll enjoy it from what I know about it. There isn't anything that seems useful. Haunting Ground's fine. Okay, I thought you meant like, oh no, God help you that you're playing Haunting Ground. I also don't know when we're going to get to that, because I had assumed... Oh god, Scissorman's going to hit us with the facts again. Ghost head, though. I haven't seen any of that game ever. I'm genuinely curious, though. Because it seems like it's the same formula as all of these. Pardon me. And these seem fine. I'm gonna find out. I'm sure I'll eat my words, but like, I don't see how this is gonna be like horrible. In fact, my cat. There are various documents on the desk. We'll go look at that last. Unless he's in the locker. Which he, I guess, maybe could be. The only, you know, this and the SNES game are pretty, like, even-footed, I think, in terms of quality. But I think the one major difference that I like a lot about the SNES game is, like, there's a lot of, what are these doing here? A pair of underpants is hanging up to dry. Oh, okay. Nothing inside that'd be useful. There's a flashlight right there! No, you look again. There's a flashlight right I see the fucking flashlight. Maybe I'm just seeing things. I'll let the first impression speak for itself. Yeah, that's fair. I fully expect to eat my words, honestly. Get ready, I'm coming to get you! The writing is weak and unsteady. I'm coming to get you! That's right, chat. Scissorman can send tax. Facts. I fucking... Again, as we were talking earlier when I was playing Helen's scenario earlier tonight, like, he's a good, like, slasher villain, but he's also so goofy sometimes, and it's hilarious. It's just, for me, I love it, like, 100% all around. Straight facts. It's too good. There are many cases on mental illness. Many files of people's names written on them. The name Dan Barrows is written in the last file. That probably is important. Can I inspect that again? No, okay, it's the same thing. It's fine. Just want to make sure I don't miss anything in here, you know? Best spawns in the computer room. Oh, where it says die, die, die. That's a good one. Domestic and international criminal records. There we go. Guess we'll call him Little JC. Yeah, like I think D314 put it best. Earlier he called him like Jason's little brother that's trying too hard or something like that. There's a telephone. It's dead. Shit, we're gonna need to restore power before we can use the ladder. Beth's desk. There's a stuffed animal and a spray can. A can of mace. Give it to me. Take it, you fucking fool. Why can't I take the mace? I'm sure that would, like, stun Scissorman at least once. Helen's desk. It's very neatly organized. There's a key! Yes! Office key. Okay. Whose office, though? Well, whatever. It's this office. Okay. It's open. Yeah, this is definitely gonna run over, but whatever. It's fine. We're, like, still in scenario one. It's almost 11 o'clock. These charts are collected here. There are many bottles of medicine. Stop. Stop it. Stop reading the bottles of medicine. There's no way there's nothing in here, right? A cheap table. Like, there's gotta be something of use in here. Why even find a key for this shit? What the fuck? Oh, maybe we still have that. Maybe there's, like, more offices we can open with that. I've had it with laying on this bed. Okay, yeah, probably like another office will open. Little Jay-Z. This room ain't rendering so well right now. I might actually just buy the Japanese version, because I'm not buying the English version of this game. But I have a PlayStation I could play it on. I guess I could just get an emulated version of the Japanese version too. That's entirely possible. I knew there wouldn't be anything useful. Emergency exit. Yeah, right. Wrong inflection. Mary Kunis. No one seems to be in there. The door is locked. What key do I have right now? Ladder key. Aren't they both grossly overpriced? No. The Japanese one's like 20 bucks. At least I saw it. It might be disc only, but I mean... fuck it. Yeah, no. It's like a... it's a not a manufacturing thing, like, supply and demand, like, part of it ties into, like, you know, very often, like, the English ports would be done later, and, like, they kind of already have ideas of, like, this happens with a lot of video games, for the record, especially a lot of, like, niche, popular horror games, where, like, you know, they got an idea of the general reception of the game from the initial release of the Japanese version. So, like, they might have printed a lot more copies of that. But then, like, oh, well, this game didn't do so good or whatever. So maybe we won't print as many in the U.S. Or maybe we don't think it's going to do as well in the U.S. So, like, it's supply and damn. So that's why a lot of those games, like, tend to be really rare if you want, like, the U.S. version or even, like, the PAL version sometimes. But not always, but that's kind of the case. There's also, like, other exceptions where, like, games are, like, the end of the life cycle of a console. Like, for example, Bomberman 64 2, the second attack. Sorry, something written here. Hint number 3, yeah, baby! Didn't mean to inspect that again. Or, like, Chip and Dale Rescue Rangers 2 on the NES. It's, like, one of the last games made on the NES. It was, like, well into the life cycle of the Super Nintendo. Where, like, they just didn't have that many copies of it because it was made so late. Starting campus is lit, baby! Campus is creepy with everyone gone. No one walking around outside. So, you know, there's reasons for it, but... doesn't always make sense. Bunk beds, no one's using them. Also, I read a thing, like, fairly recently about, bunk beds for napping. Helen must take naps here when it gets late. Alright, there's nothing more to gather in here. I think this room is just for the clue. Anyway, I was reading about a thing recently about, like, this weird... wait, can I take that? Maybe that's for defense against Scissorman or something, I don't know. It's weird that I can inspect it, though, when he's not here. Yeah, there's, like... I don't really want to call it a conspiracy, because it's actually, like, pretty, like, identifiably true. I don't remember the name of the company anyway, but there's, like a rating company, you know, for, like... Shit, what do you call it? When you get, like, things rated, like, for, like, reselling their, like, older, like, antiques or whatever. There's, like, this, like, pseudo-conspiracy of, like, things going on with, why retro games have, like, spiked in prices, but I don't think that necessarily applies to used games, more so, like, better condition games that are like CIB or like mint condition stuff like that, or unopened stuff. So not quite tying into the price of like a game you might try to buy off eBay or whatever, but I'm not very good at computers. Same Jennifer as a programmer. I wonder if it's being repaired. Personal computer. I might break it if I touch it. Damn! Well, she is like 12 or whatever, I guess, so. Not 12, she's 15, you said? I don't know. Not necessarily computer savvy. 12 in, like, the 90s. 90s of, like, not Norway. Where are we? I forget exactly. So, shit. Why? I guess it has been, like, a solid minute since we last saw him, but still, why? Come here, Scissorman, I got something for you. Maybe we just don't find a flashlight here. Oh, there's no broom in here. Shit. This is not the bathroom I thought it was. Yeah, Norway. Oh, shit. I was right. Alright, cool. Why can't I leave? Oh, right click. Left click to get in there, right click to get out. I mean, I don't think we can leave yet anyway, because I need to, like, restore power. Maybe I go back out the door I came in or something? But this might have something in it, too, so I'm gonna go look at it. From way up here, is it safe? I should have saved before I left. Oh well. Too late now. We could have left, like, immediately. Well, we got oil now. I assume that does something for us eventually. Yeah, it's gotta be end of scenario, right? And done, yeah. Could have immediately gone up there if I wanted to, but... I hope that at least one of the items we got will help us later. We also found some clues. My ears. Everyone's ears. Oh, I did get everything. That's good to know. Thanks. What in the fuck is going on? We haven't even solved the last case yet. And now another mass murder? And again, you're saying that murderer is a monster? But it's true. I can already see tonight's headlines. Scissorman's back. Dot, dot, dot. Well, whether he exists or not, you should go home now and rest. We posted a policeman outside your house, so you'll be safe, surely. Thank you, Inspector. That's Assistant Inspector. Wait, what? Alright, chat, give me 1 second. I know we're still here and everything. We need to keep talking to him. Also, my mouse totally got out of whack again. I can't save right now. That's okay. Nothing's gonna happen if I walk away. Enjoy the random LED hum as I take a quick break. I'll be right back.
Alrighty.
Helen's staring into your soul.
Hey, welcome on in, Shadow X Stripes.
It was the Scissorman. I know, I believe you, Jennifer. He's just being stubborn. I heard that teach. I heard that at same distance as Jennifer distance. Anyway, if it's him, we have to figure out some way to destroy him. We can do it. Yes. Yes, smiley face. What should I do now? Let's go around first. I wonder what Nolan's doing. Do not engage with this fucking creepy guy. Why did I go in here, actually? This man is the cameraman who was with Nolan. Excuse me, is Nolan here? Hey, you're Jennifer! Yes, I am. Is Nolan here? Nolan? He just went to look for you. He's worried about you. Oh, is he? He should be back in a bit. But I don't think you should wait here. Why not? Well, you're hot stuff again. And if the other reporters find you, they'll ask you questions till... questions apostrophe till the cows come home. Suppose you're right. I'll come back later then. I'll leave the back door open for you, so try not to be seen when you come in. Thank you. Loading. Yeah, I don't think I can bring up the save screen right now. I wonder if Helen's here. University Research Building. She's here. We found her. Oh, hi, Jennifer. You came just in time. I was just on my way out. Where are you going? Do you remember that statue? The one they found at the scene of the clock tower murders? Singular, I guess. What about it? I can't find it anywhere. Professor Barton had it. And Professor Barton was called away on some police business. Do you have any idea where it might be? Yes, I found some telephone numbers on the professor's desk. One for the library and one for a man... Oh, shit. I thought I would go to the police station to initiate this. For a man named Rick. I think he must have taken it to one of them. He did mention to me that he would like to get an expert opinion of the statue. I don't know who this Rick person is, though. I see. Anyway, I'll go to the library to see Mr. Sullivan. The statue's there. I've got to get it. I want anything and everything relating to the Scissorman. Yes. Helen, I'll find out who this Rick person is. Maybe Nolan knows something about him. Jennifer. Yes? Who is Nolan? Ah. Well, I'd better run along now. Jennifer, no. He's too old. I'm going to the library. No reason to go to the library. Wrong. Categorically incorrect. I wonder if Edward and Kay are attacked by Scissorman. I wonder. So I love that one person's like, oh, I'm not worried about being attacked because he's after you, when so many people have been like laid to waste. I know there is no one here. Alongside them being chased by the Scissorman. I think that was Harris, right? That's not till the next scenario, but whatever. These motherfuckers are gonna make me go back to my house, aren't they? Probably shouldn't bother the inspector. Okay, so we had to do all that, I'm pretty sure. I'll bet my house is surrounded by reporters. I probably shouldn't go home for a while just yet.
I guess we go back to Nolan. Hope Nolan is there. And then we just tell him to not go to Rick's house, probably, I'm guessing. Because we don't... We told... At the beginning, we did not send... What's his name? Harris. No, wait, no. The other guy. No, that is Harris. Jennifer, are you alright? Yes, thank you. The police didn't want to tell me much, so I had a hard time finding you. Motherfucker, I found you. Is there anything I could do? Okay, yeah, so no. No is the answer. Actually, yes, there is. No. Do you know a man named Rick? I think he's involved in the clock tower case. I was just gonna interview him. Really? He used to be a butler in the Barrows family. I ran into someone who happened to know that. Thought I'd go ask him what he knew about the Barrows family. And if we get locked into ending E, we're just gonna, like, deal with that and play something else, I guess, afterwards. Well, Professor Barton might have given the statue to him. I knew it was gonna say, chat. You mean the one that they found at the scene of the murder? Yes, I want every little clue relating to this murder. Or the case. Okay. Should I get the statue from him? No. No. What? No! Alright, I'll go see him and get it. Well... No. Oh my god, I have to right-click on that for some reason. Thank you for offering, but Helen is looking for it now. Okay, no problem. If you ever do need help, just let me know. Thank you, Nolan. I bet Nolan's scenario is pretty similar. So, it's a shame because this is going to be... Oh, wait, scenario 2, Edward, what? Oh, okay, that's... This is going to be exactly the same as we did last time, except we're going to find the statue this time, I'm pretty sure. So maybe not exactly the same. Oh, my dog. Mr. Sullivan? He's in the head... He is in the head librarian's office. I see. Thank you. Cool. We're on the route to get the good ending. Well, I'm gonna try to get ending A, but if we don't, whatever. I could just cheat and read the guide. But, well, if it isn't Edward, what are you doing here? It's boring at the hotel. Suspicious child. Totally not the clock tower murderer. Ignoring what we already know from the three endings we've gotten as Helen. That's okay though, chat. I'm sure this is Mr. Sullivan's office. The most important thing though is we're gonna get to see the best thing in this game, period. Soon. Very soon. Hello, Helen! It's been a long time, hasn't it, Mr. Sullivan? I've heard about what happened to you. How terrible. Yes. Alright, bye. By the way, Mr. Sullivan. Yes, I have heard. There is something you would like to research? I will give you a key to the reading room so that you can use the reference materials as you please. The reading room is right next door. Oh, and the statue? Oh, yes, that's it. Professor Barton left it with me. Please come pick it up on your way out. Thank you very much, Mr. Sullivan. Every time, man. Just double input because this fucking mouse control is garbage. It's the emulator's fault, not the game, probably. Oh, beans, I missed the weed game. Yeah, by a lot. There's always the VOD, as they say. Literally everyone that probably would have appreciated... Well, that's not true. That's not true at all. There was plenty of people here memeing when we were playing the weed game. Welcome back, Carly. Now I can enter the reading room. You haven't missed too much of this game. We're about halfway through right now. that's worth anything. Possum told me I should play it at 8:20 because that would be 4:20 your time, but there was no way we were going to finish this game by then. Made a weed cocktail. Got my weed. Nice. The reading room. There are many valuable works here, only available to university personnel. I just hope there's something here that will explain the Scissorman. Show of hands in chat. Does anyone bother that I say Scissorman instead of Scissorman? If so, I don't care, but I'm curious. A stepladder? Books relating to England are up there. We go look at them. Now maybe that's not what we need to look at. I forgot what we did. Which book we need to look at in here? This is a book I've been wanting to read for a long time. This is hardly a good time. Okay, well, I think I need to climb the stepladder or something. I thought it was over here, but I guess not. Oh yeah, okay. There we go. Lords of Northern England. This is it. Scissorman instead of Scissorman seems fine. Excuse me, but the library will be closing soon. Oh, I see. Ignored. Fuck you, clerk, who doesn't even get a name. I found a clue about Scissorman. I still have to pick up the statue. I hope y'all are ready for this. Carly, you did get here just in time for this. Strange, the clock is chiming. Get ready for this. Oh, Mr. Sullivan. Helen. It seems the bells of the giant clock are broken. I think I will go have a look. Well, I will go with you. Thank you. Please follow me. This is one of the best moments of this game.
The clock hasn't been working for ages. I wonder if someone has been messing with it.
Help me, step Helen. there it is. That was it. Fucking rip. And now we do violence against the Scissorman. Oh wait, wrong area. Well, that's okay, we can do this. I meant to click the other door. My bad. Get fucking laddered, idiot. Edward's voice is heard from upstairs. That's Edward's voice? Got him. He can't still be here. He's not allowed to still be here.
Helen?
That's Edward's voice, and it's coming from inside that room. So this is verbatim what we saw on Helen's ending
Edward.
E.
Edward.
And you could actually still get ending A with Helen doing this part as well, which is weird. Goddamn. Chain. Sentient chain that just tangled around my ankle. Alright, this time we're gonna get him good, chat. Trust me. Hello? There we go. I don't trust you. Well, trust this. Shasha! Lamp! Lamp attack! So, presumably there will be a key somewhere in this building. Got him. I like that somehow your mod badge went away. I'm not inspecting that corpse because she will, a magazine. Smile on the model of the, on the cover looks fake. Get banned. I don't know why that happened. There's so many people a moment ago. Again, I said this last time, but there were like three people a moment ago. Now there's just us. You know, it's not that wild, I guess. That's all I'm saying. Scanning. Scanga. Computing for managing the library. I hope it is networked to the outside. Why do you hope that, Helen? Who cares? Plant, it doesn't seem useful. We have zero items right now, is Helen. Side note. Same comment, okay. Please let there be the key to that random room back here somewhere. That's Tommy. Not Tommy. What the fuck is his name? Jeremiah, maybe? Probably. Totally. Everything seems normal here. Nothing that seems useful. Circle desk in perfect order. I'll bet everyone has gone home. Where is the key? I need a key. They're obviously having budgetary problems here too. Just like at the university. Pretty presumptuous of you, but okay, whatever. Files line the shelves. There's gotta be a key somewhere in here, right? Calendars hang up on the wall. Today isn't Friday the 13th. Oh yeah. It certainly isn't Thursday the 20th.
Edward, I thought you'd still be here. It's dangerous here. Come with me.
Definitely not the Scissor Man.
You hide under this table until I call you.
Wait, where was the screwdriver? Oh, we had to... Oh, right. We had to examine this first.
And don't worry. We'll make it.
And then we can find the screwdriver. That was the bullshit that made me very angry my first time playing this. Okay, so now we know that's covered with screws or whatever. That's it. Edward can fit through it. He's small. If I could just get the screen off. Now, we can find the screwdriver over here on this motherfucker's desk. Oh, maybe his door's actually opened. That might also be a thing. No. We need the key. Envelopes, documents related to multiple personalities on the desk. The sender of the envelopes is Professor Barton. I really shouldn't look inside, but I will, though. I wonder if there's anything else. A key. Definitely a key. Oh! A key is inside the drawer. You now have the collection room key. Which is the collection I'm sure the collection room is in the back. Yeah. Sorry, Chet. Everything is normal here. Smiley face. Where the fuck is that screwdriver, though? Oh, no. It's back in the room where we found Edward. I remember now. But we need to go in here first. Now I can enter the collection room. Probably where the statue is, which is what we need. Don't walk away. Oh my god, Helen. Jesus fucking Christ. Collection room is where Mr. Sullivan keeps the artifacts dug up in Egypt and other places, of which he is very proud. He's very proud of Egypt, Chet. But this time, it's pitch dark inside. Didn't there used to be an aquarium in here? I could use the light from it. Found it. You son of a bitch! You can't do that. This game is too silly sometimes. This game walks the tightrope of silliness and horror incredibly well. It's so fucking good, man. Okay, I cannot inspect that clerk that's totally dead. That shit's too funny, man. I don't know. This has to be like the safe spot in this area, because if it's not, I don't know what is, honestly. Dude, she turned into a crypt, and look at her fucking arms right now. Her arms are longer than her entire body currently. He has no style, he has no grace. This Kong has a funny face. Listen, Chet, I simultaneously don't wish that this had happened, and also do wish it had happened, but I wish the Mario movie had Lanky Kong in it. The end. I will not be taking further questions. It's in one of these desks. I think it's this desk. It has a screwdriver. We'll only that later, but not yet. We need to find the fucking statue first. I wonder if there's anything useful in here. Screwdriver's in one of the drawers. You have obtained the screwdriver. Like, the movie already has, like, too much shit jammed into it. No! 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 What? No! Someone wants to call the police. Hey! No, no, open the menu. Open the menu. Oh my god. Open the menu, but let me actually load game. No! Don't save- Oh my fucking god. Why are the controls so bad in this game? Stop. Load game. Go back. I am not- We cannot inspect this door right now. Some fucking bullshit, man. Oh, you went in there to get the screwdriver? Oh, well, fuck you. The cops are here now. Fuck you, Tommy. Not Tommy. Fuck you, Tommy Vercetti. The fuck? What the hell is the kid's name? No, it is Tom. It is Tommy, isn't it? No, it's not Tommy. Edward. Edward is his name. God, why can I not remember the fucking kid's name? I literally cannot. It's the one character I cannot remember for some reason. I mean, I can. Enough time, but... We know exactly what we need to do now, so just ignore... Well, don't ignore Scissor Man, because he's gonna fucking come for us again. Soon, but No. Here. Blah 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 blah. Blah 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 blah. Blah 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 blah. This is different dialogue than we got the first time we were in here locked into ending E. But that makes sense because the statue wasn't here in the library, so like it makes sense that they just kind of like locked us out of like anything useful in this area. Okay, we got the key to the recollection room or whatever. Not recollection, the collection room. It's like kind of Resident Evil 1. Costume. What the fuck are they called? The special? I don't even. Costume. I think it's just called the costume key. I don't know what the fuck I was thinking of. My brain, chat. I could use the light from this. Nothing bad will happen when I do this. Thank goodness, the power is on here. He's not here now. That was great, though. It's really unfortunate that it, like, forces into a bad ending. There are many ancient swords, strange symbol, strangely shaped pots, and other valuable artifacts. Cool. Where is the statue, though? It's right there, I see it. Take the statue. Mr. Sullivan probably kept it here. The statue is together with the other artifacts. Oh, thank goodness. There it is. You now have a statue. Since I have what I came for now, all I have to do is find a way out. Okay, we need to go get Edward, and then I think the exit will appear. How were all these giant statues carried in here? Probably magic. The Gathering. You know. I'm like 99% we already have this clue. Because I feel like clues are like persistent across playthroughs. But just in case we don't, I'm getting it. I'm gonna go back and I'm gonna get it. The operation panel of the giant clock is covered with rust. Damn it! If we were Jennifer, we'd have oil to deal with that rust. Big decision. You'll get the choice of asking Harris to take the statue to Rick. You get the choice of yes or no. Choose one. Yes means he'll take it to Rick. No means you'll... Barton will take it the statue. What? It's just copy-pasta. What the fuck are you doing? No means he'll take the statue to Mr. Sullivan, head of the librarian. Don't forget who it's gone to, as this is very important. Yeah, no. That's that we... Okay, I thought that was a meme you were posting at me. I actually thought that was just a meme. That determines whether we go to the library or Rick's house. So in our last playthrough, we went to the library first, then I reloaded my save file, and we went to Rick's house. I thought you were just fucking around. I knew what was going on immediately. I wonder if I could have inspected the grate to make this go along faster.
It's dangerous here. Come with me.
But yeah, basically that just tells us like where we should go.
You hide under this table until I call you.
So, we are supposed to be in the library this time, and...
Good boy, and don't worry, we'll make it.
I guess the library is always Helen, regardless of whether you're playing as Helen or Jennifer. But Rick's house, you either play as the policeman Gott, or you play as Nolan if you're on Jennifer's playthrough, which is what we're doing right now. But in the beginning, we set the statue here to the library, which is different than our last playthrough. If you go to the place where the statue isn't, you get ending E, which is like the short ending, basically. But it's also just like, you go home, and the other character's dead already! And also, you're fucking dead now too, basically. I'm kind of glad that this will end shortly as soon as I grab the screwdriver over here. Oh, I didn't even need to grab a screwdriver this time. A police siren car is heard. Someone must have called the police. It was me. Door cannot be opened from the front. Many policemen are swarming around outside, looking for a way in. There are so many people just on the other side of the door. Chad, I'm stupid. Okay. The police showing up was not gonna force us to, like, end the scenario. So we didn't need to, like, redo that stuff, but it's fine. Like, we're still almost done anyway. No, don't look at that fucking computer. Damn it, Helen. Stop looking at computers. Go look at screwdriver instead. It's okay to be stupid. I do it 24/7. My mouse is out of sync again, so I need to pause the game for a second here. This mouse setting is pretty good, but it's not perfect for sure, honestly. So we go open the grate for little Timmy or whatever his name is. No, wait, Tim is a different guy. Tim's the cameraman, the reporter people. Edward is his name. There we go. I'm not even gonna look at that clerk. She's fucking dead. She's obviously dead. And that's just like a forced scissorman spawn, so I'm not gonna do that. If you want to see what that looks like, go look at my Helen playthrough, because I did that on my E-ending playthrough of Helen. Oh, let's go, baby. Screwdriver. Unscrew. Go talk to Edward real quick. Edward,
come out from here.
I don't even need to.
Edward, you can probably squeeze through here to the outside. Hurry, run away from here.
Okay, I will.
Don't mind me, chat. Just sitting here drinking some water, that's all. And we're done with this scenario, finally. Didn't take quite as long as the first scenario,
hey,
I guess.
Teach, what's going on? Teach, hang in there.
That's right, chat. I've switched off of beer into pure vodka, totally not water. You're right, you caught me. I wonder if she found the statue. Sorry, I will be right back. I got a tinkle, and I'm grabbing more water as well. Be right back. Mm-hmm.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine, but you just can't get into it because they would never understand.
How many times do we have to teach you this lesson, old man?
Sorry about that, babe.
Alrighty. Oh no. What has happened? What do you guys think about Goonies in here? I think I'm missing them. I hope she found the statue alright. And she did, though. Oh shit. My mouse is fucked up again. There we go. I'm going to Rick's house now. Rick's house. No, that's just Rick's house, the end. I must go see Helen quickly. I fantasize about Goon's House of Horror too. It could happen. I was thinking about that today, actually. Weirdly enough. Where is she? I don't know where to go see her. Oh my fucking god, it's the last thing I click on. Like, she could be at our house? I don't know. Fucking goddammit. I feel like if I continue that series, it's going to be released in, like, the same chronological order as Resident Evil. Sister Man was in the library, huh? Gots was just questioning me. You aren't hurt, are you? No, I'm alright, fist bump. I was also able to get the statue. Oh, I need to talk to her again. But more importantly, found a clue to the Scissorman. What is it? Question mark, question mark. Found out where the Barrows used to live before they immigrated here. They used to live in the Barrows Castle in England. The Barrows Castle. According to historical accounts of the castle, there was some kind of monster born there. You know. Historical accounts. Jennifer's response to that statement. They must have found some way to destroy the monster back then. So if we go to the Barrows Castle, we might learn how they did it? Right. I can't say we will for sure. But I want to believe we will if we try. Okay, I'll tell the others. Good. Be sure to tell Gots. He'll bug us later if we don't. We should also tell Professor Barton. Okay, I'll go now then. Hotel. I should tell Edward and Kay. Yeah, tell the fucking Scissorman, I guess. Why not? Fuck it. Oh, Jennifer. Well, hello, Jennifer. I think we're getting closer to discovering the secret to Scissorman. The secret to Scissorman? Yes, there's a castle in England called the Barrow's Castle. Why, hello, Mr. Goon and Watch. Hello, Samurai Jen. How are you doing? Welcome on in. Fuck, I missed a line there. I see. Is that where the Scissorman is from? I didn't miss a line, actually. That was the same. Pretty good. Nice. Likewise. Thanks. So Helen and I are going to England to investigate the castle. Just got done watching You are? Is that a good idea? Well, maybe dangerous, but I'll go with you, Jennifer. What? Edward? Don't be ridiculous. If we don't do something, he'll probably kill us too. May I go with you, Jennifer? Okay, I'll tell Helen. Oh dear. I've never seen any of the Kingsman movies. There's like, there's just two of them, right? Pardon me. Never take your eyes off Scissorman lore. Rick's house. I don't know why I clicked on that. I'm going to Police Street last. We're gonna talk to everybody. And we're gonna intentionally murder Nolan. I don't know if that matters for A rank or A rank, A ending, but I don't care. This man is no good. Jennifer, it seems Mr. Sullivan was killed by a Scissorman in the library with the giant clock. I know, Helen was there too. Is that right? The police didn't tell us that much. Nolan, we found a clue. Really? Yes, there's a castle in England called the Barrow's Castle, and we now know where it is. The Barrow's Castle, that must be where Scissorman's from. Yes, that's right. So you must have Pizza Samurai, Jen? You know what kind? Okay, we'll go too, right, Tim? Yeah, this will make one interesting report. You don't mind, do you, Jennifer? Of course not. Feel safer if you come along. Alright then. We'll go ask our boss. I'm intentionally gonna let Nolan die. That man is a fucking creeper. Talking to 15-year-old Jennifer. Literally asking her on a date in this game, by the way. Totally not the fucking weirdest thing ever. It says I can't go in. It says, ho. Is it a Christmas pizza, D314? Not to steal someone else's meme, but you know. Jennifer, we heard you're going to the Barrows. Ah, he is talking about the Christmas pizza. Well, yes, we decided to go with you too. You have? This will be a good chance to see a castle, and it sounds like fun. Beth, you're gonna fucking die. I see. She actually is gonna... it might be different on Jennifer's playthrough, I don't know, but... Oh, our mouse is super fucked right now, hold on. This mouse plugin kind of fucking sucks, actually. Is Jen's meme really? That's fair. I didn't know where it originated from, to be fair. We went to the hotel, we went to the newspaper company, we tried to go to Rick's house, I don't think there's a purpose of going home at this point. So let's go to Police Street. I wonder if the inspector's in. Just to make sure the inspector comes with us. If not, that's kind of a problem. Slice pizza is disgusting seafood pizza. Hi, Jennifer. Aaron, Scissorman is back. The media is going to jump all over it again. This is indeed an interesting case. I would love to see Scissorman. Jennifer just says him like 90% of the time, but she is a teenager. I I don't like seafood in general. I don't like seafood pizzas, but... Senator Gotz, I'm going to England. It's Assistant Gotz to you. Or Assistant Inspector. Are you going to go? Sorry, are you going there to study? No, not really. There's a case called the... There's a castle called the Barrow's Castle in England. If I go there, maybe I'll be able to learn something about Scissor Man. The Barrow's Castle? So that is where the Barrows used to live before they immigrated to Norway. I think so. Now we talk to him. That sounds rather interesting. I will accompany you as well. Hold on a second, Professor. What about that castle? You too, Jennifer. You're an important witness in this case. You can't just trapeze off like that? Then come with us, huh? There must be some reason as to why the murderer disguises himself as Scissor Man. We might learn why investigating in the Barrow's Castle. History. Whatever. Alright, Professor. I'll go. But what am I gonna say? What am I gonna say to my boss? No need to worry. You will be a hero if the case is solved. As long as I ain't made a goat. What? This guy's a Scissor Man, if that's already a known killer. Copycat killers. I cannot save during these intermissions. No, you're on point. Everything is, you know. About right. Hi, Jennifer. I was just checking the number of people going to the Barrow's Castle. People are now a total of 10 people. I'm a bit concerned that some of them think this is going to be a picnic. Oh. Oh well. We'll leave on the first flight in the morning. I've already arranged for a rental car. Hope we can find a way to destroy him, Jennifer. Me too. Me three. Ow! Oh, we're already there. Okay, well. I think we did everything. And this is still just as obnoxious to listen to. The sun is going down. That audio right now. It'd be dangerous to move out in the dark. Let's camp here. Okay, so the same setup at least. I'm gonna save as soon as we get into the castle because I don't want to redo that again. Regardless of what happens. I'm not gonna like be a stickler for A rank. Strange, where's Jennifer? Teach, have you seen Harris and Edwards? Kay is looking all over for them, but she can't find them anywhere. Like how they have no roads in England? Yeah, that's about right. Jennifer's missing too. They can't be missing. The castle, hurry! Don't tell me I'm gonna play as Helen right now. That can't- No. Last scenario. Scissor Man. Yeah, we're not playing anything else tonight, I'm sorry, chat. If I have roofed you in any way, shape, or form- Huh?
Don't be afraid, Jennifer. It's me, Harris.
What? Why?
Poor girl. Don't worry. I'll help you now.
With my giant scissors.
Where are we? Where is everyone? What's that costume?
What the fuck indeed?
He told me. He told me that if I kidnap you, he will give you to me.
Harris is 35, oh no. Still taller than him, though. A little manlet.
Jennifer!
No, don't come any closer!
The real Scissor Man. He cometh. That's basically 14 in Norwegian years. Oh no. Oh no, chat. Don't you be sacrificing Helen out here. Right, he's not. Kind of already fucked things up. What is that, like, thing in the corner over there? What's happening? I think we just save over this one. I don't think I care about this anymore. This is fun. F. F that guy, more like, you know? I can't hide in the pews. I can't go out the front thing. I'm going over here. We're gonna trap him in- oh my god! Literally, oh my gods. Wait, hold on. Here we go. Get fucking ready to get wrecked, bitch. You know, this is way too much for a game this old, but like, this is like a thing where you could like use one of these things to accidentally kill another survivor. To the F was for, fair enough. Gats got fucking giga murked over there. What is this? What is this? It's copper plate on the wall. Mine now, I guess. There are stars drawn on it. You have the star plate. Okay. Thanks. I guess. I don't know. It's fucking weird. Yeah, it was the sun. Oh, wait, was it the sun? Hold on. Oh, shit. It was the moon. It was actually the moon, though. Moon was on top. That was it. I think. Yeah, it really doesn't show me again, does it? Hopefully I just need to remember it was on top and nothing else, because, I do remember it was on top. But, beyond that, I'm lost. It's okay, I can just pause the game, go look at my VOD, and find out what it said there. Is this a different statue this time around? It is. So the Virgin Mary, something is very wrong. How spooky. The extra spooky Virgin Mary. An old tattered Bible. Pretty sure when you run in touch room of being chased, Gots will always get got. Oh shit. Well, he's dead now. Rip Gots. Priest robes, the color is completely faded, huh? There's something in the pocket. You now have the stair key. Stair. Stair. Surely Scissorman won't bother us until we get back to things, right? Religious books from many different countries, it's probably the same, but I'll check anyway. I don't like to read. I like both Helen and... Helen would love these books. Helen and Jennifer both don't read, but Helen's like, I have no time to read, and Jennifer is just like, I don't like reading. Just looking at these books gives me a headache. Two paths leading to the same spot, right, chat? So I cannot leave through here yet. Maybe Gots had something on him that we go back and look at now. There's something on the floor here. What is it? Oh, that stench! Large candles on the floor. You now have the candle. Okay. Thanks. Chains are hanging from the wall. Many people must have been hung in them. A keyhole. Oh, a keyhole. Hold on. I don't have any keys, but... Oh, wait. I do have a key, actually. Hold on. Where'd I get this? Instruments of torture. They look painful. Rip. Rip Gots. Literally rip him. Boom, baby. Some stairs. A circus. I wonder where it leads. Man, so many people are like forced to die in Jennifer's playthrough. It's kind of nuts. Like, I don't have another option than to run to the torture room as Jennifer, though, right? Because there's like, there's three rooms I can go in, and none of them have hiding places, or not hiding places, but like, things I can protect myself with other than that room, right? This room isn't like any of the others. Pardon. This room isn't like any of the others. Wow. The front's all scratched up. The Mary statue room has one? Really? Oh, shit. I've tried to protect myself in there a couple times, and it's always, like, failed. Portrait of a beautiful woman. Other than, you know, just, like, the generic, like, dodge him attack thing. I've tried to throw the statue at him. I've tried the coat rack. I think I've tried everything in there, but I don't know. Maybe it's different as Jennifer. I don't know. Oh, yeah. Right. Yeah, I know you can hide behind the books. The coat rack is what works? Oh, shit. I must have just misclicked or something. When I was in there the one time and tried it. Oh well, Gots is dead, that's fine. Totally fine. Although he might have given us a gun, and now he won't. And maybe Helen's dead in this ending, and we're gonna ending B for Jennifer, which will be like the same thing but with Jennifer. Wow, what a mansion. That's what Jennifer said, just trust me. So we don't have a flashlight. There's the library key over there, which I'll go look at. My hair is a mess! I forget what this is, but I don't think it's of any importance. Oh yeah, no, that's what triggers this, which will let us get the library key. Oh wait, there's not even a fucking fireplace in here. Okay, it's completely different. Okay. I think that mouse ran in here. Ah. Small hole in the wall behind the table. A key. Okay, that is the library key. Cool. This is just a hiding place. Glory. at like floor level. Closet. Very old coats hung along inside. Okay, yeah, so that's just entirely just for hiding. Nothing else. Especially the master bedroom. The bed looks luxurious. So the master bedroom. The bed looks luxurious. Okay. Same dealio. Master bedroom, but also two separate beds, I guess. Whatever. Fucking whatever, it's fine. I gotta inspect, like, everything, honestly, because it's probably a completely different way. I'm gonna assume that door over there is still at least, like, a crater and nothing is useful in there. Wonder when it was last used. It's covered with dust. Let's go get the manor key. If it's still here, I don't know. Could be in an entirely different location, but we'll find it one way or the other, right? sturdy wooden cabinet. It's empty. What about this? Glorious. Looks like a vase. Cool. A pot. Strangely, it isn't rusty. Oh. Okay, well, that's unfortunate. There's no key here this time. Shit. Sofa, it's covered with dust. I wouldn't want to sit here. Yeah. Well, you're still here, at least. If anything's consistent, I suppose, there's that. I want to try this real quick. I don't know if this will work. If it doesn't, whatever. But, I gotta know. Oh god, please. Please. Jennifer, go. Wait. Will I get scared by what's his name? No, he's dead. He's literally fucking dead right now. We know he's dead. Because that was Harris last time, right? Oh, I can't click on that. Okay, well, I don't know what that fucking hole is down there. Then, if it's not a place you can hide from Scissorman, I don't know what that's for. Don't kill me, please. Yeah, he's... You fucking cunt. Jesus Christ. Hooray, RNG! Love it. Fucking love it, man. Oh, well. I'm gonna go bop this motherfucker with a goddamn pan. How about that shit? Oh, he's already over there. Hold on, we got this. Yay. I can't click it when he's already in the room, damn it! Ah, shit. Fine, I'll just go walk off a fucking cliff, I guess. Get him that way. That film is good. That's a different angle than it is for Helen. Weirdly. I'm heckin' angry, chat. Wait, hold on. That took less stamina for us. Sorry. When in doubt, jump out. True. Because of her skirt. Yeah. Just not quite as soulful as the other playthrough, you know what I'm saying? Or whatever the fucking weirdos that hate RE4 remakes say. Wait, something stuck at the bottom? What did it say? There is something stuck to the bottom. Oil. Lube it up. I can't reach the oil. Eh. Don't get it twisted. I don't think that everyone that does not like RE4 Remake is that way. However, there is a weird percentage of people that seem to be dying on a hill of just like, wow, I can't look up this character's skirt, and therefore this game is not as good as the original version. Floorboards are loose. Loosen it up with some oil then, even more. Okay, it didn't work. For a second, I thought that actually worked, but, yeah, no. So, in the one room, I think it's, like, next to the library, there's, like, a, wait, do we have the library key? No, well, if we did, I don't think I'd know, actually, because it's, like, a different thing. Yeah. I'm lost. I guess we gotta look around then. It's almost like I had to explore all the rooms, and they've shuffled things around so that I have a fresh experience, even though I've played the game at this point. Is this the same? I guess I'll just try it, right? Yeah, it kind of is the same, it looks like. Oh. It's a book on the bed. A large book. The cover is made of copper. You now have the copper book. File drawer. Hair is scattered about. Well, good for them. Ugh! Dude, I don't know how much you have to click this fucking shit. It's a ridiculous amount. Gak! Ooh, gag! Click the fucking quill, please. Ag! There is nothing inside. Ah, shit. It's bait. It's all bait. Yellowed with age. They got me. They got me good. Closet stuffed clothes. Okay, so that's a hiding spot, as usual. Indeed. Jebaited indeed. Maybe there's something out here. I doubt it, but I'm gonna check anyway. Oh, hey, man. How you doing? Everybody's fucking dead. Oh no! Shit. Just hanging out, you know. Just hanging out. Hanging out. Hanging out with the family. You know what's happening, though. Fuck you, Scissor Man. I got full stamina, I can afford this. Having ourselves a party. That's pretty much all there is to the song. Alright, does he have anything on him? Oh, I haven't been in here yet. I should go in the rock room. I don't know what that room's actually called, but... yes, it's about it. Infinite dunking himself in the depths. Okay, I can't inspect him, I think. Unless this does something. That's the door? Are you fucking kidding me? What? Seriously? Well, we'll go over here anyway, because there's nothing else really interesting over that way. Wait. No, okay. Nolan doesn't give us a key that we need. So he can fucking die, unless he's in a different spot. Then, whatever. He survives, he survives. Most people are not surviving right now, I'm noticing. Wait, this is this area. What? Oh, wait, no, I knew that, actually. Shit. Okay, well... well, shit. Not that door, please. Go in here. I doubt there's anything useful in here, but just in case. Honestly, we'll probably find Beth, and then she'll get fucking... no? Okay. Let's say she gets dragged to hell via... wait, what's this? Via Scissor Man. It's too dark, I can't see anything. Go down anyway. Do it. Alright. Not helpful. Yeah, no, I guess this is just an evasion spot. Yeah. Confirmed, I suppose. Good to know. Chat, I apologize. This water is running straight through me. I'll be back in a moment and we'll finish this chapter and the game, incidentally. Hello, chat. It's my stream now. No, fuck. I give it up now, I suppose. Alright, I'm back. Copper book, we've got the candle. I don't know what that does. Stair key. Maybe I should go in here. I don't know. I can't imagine what I'd find in here unless it's somebody that's going to give me a key, but yeah, no, it's nothing. That door. Maybe we can get out from there. Jump it. This is going to kill me, isn't it? The floor is caved in. I'm gonna save again. I think this is okay to save over this guy. Try it, Jennifer. Alright, fine. Be a coward. Well, we didn't get to fully explore this room, to be fair, but I don't know what else might be in here, though. The second floor has been pretty thoroughly explored overall. Oh no. You started a chain. What have you done? Oh yeah? Oh yeah, Scissor Man? Oh yeah. Bop. You motherfucker. Maybe I go through another chimney or something. I don't know. I'm actually not sure which room has anything in it I haven't already looked at, you know? I haven't examine these portraits, but, like, it doesn't seem to do anything. Portraits in a row, they seem to be glaring at me. Uh-huh. I can't even examine the one that usually falls down either, so it's just kind of like, whatever, really. And we've examined everything else in here, except for the chimney, I guess, but I doubt there's anything in here, I guess? I don't, maybe I'm wrong, I don't fucking know. What a big fireplace. Yeah. It's about what I expected, honestly. Wow, what a fireplace. This is not the kitchen, this is the other room, right? But then, no, we've already been in here too, it's like... Where do I go, man? I don't... Wait, do we have the mansion key? We don't. We actually have, like, no keys at all. Where does it want me to go? Oh my god. I'm gonna look this up. I'm actually gonna look this up. What random surface was there a key on that I didn't fucking look at? Maybe one of the pews back in the other area? Although I don't know if I can go back there or not. I might actually not be able to. Or is this just opened over here? No, this is closed. Okay. It won't even budge. Alright. Yeah, fuck this. where's... Not scenario one is Jennifer. Give me scenario three is Jennifer. Weapon, the umbrella. Thanks. Scenario three is Jennifer. Here we go. Clothes rack. You can't miss it. Cool. If you want ending A or ending B, read the box. If you want ending C or D, continue after the box. Oh, this box. Go to the first door on your right. Look at what appears to be a ladder. This will enable you to look at the bookcase behind it. You will obtain foreign note. Jennifer cannot read this because it's in Latin. Need someone to translate it. What? I guess I should go back there if we want ending A or B. Oil can open the door? This door? Seriously? Which door? I was like, wait, actually, which door? That would have confused me. It's the same message we got when we didn't have the key for that door over there. Yeah, no, yeah, okay, that's more what I expected. I just found out about a retro horror game that's coming out later this year, or an indie retro style horror game that's coming out later this year. It's not till the end of the year, but hope it's good. Yeah, no, I think that's exactly what I need to do based on the thing I was just reading. So we're going back. Yo, Maker. Thanks for the raid. Yeah, we're gonna get that note. What's up, everybody? How's it going? Oh no, I can't go back through, can I? Wait, how do I go back through? Oh no! Uh-oh. Well, we have our save from the beginning of the scenario, I think? Maybe? Maybe we don't, actually. But yeah. Welcome on in, thanks for the raid. We are playing Clock Tower for the PS1. Not to be confused with the PS1 port of the Super Nintendo Clock Tower game. I'm alright, thanks, Tomfoolery. This looks like a door in a chapel. It won't even budge. Uh-oh. Chat, I think I already screwed up. Hold on, can I load... I mean, I can load an old save file. What's the last save file we made? Well, not the last one, but the last, Oh, crap. Yeah, I'm not doing the whole chapter over. Screw that. Sorry, we're gonna get a bad ending, I guess. That's the way the cookie crumbles, so be it. Don't care. I just want out. What the fuck do I do, though? Like, I actually have no idea what Demon wants me to do right now, because I need the mansion key. In Helen's playthrough, you get that on the one table. Let me go find where you get it as Jennifer, because I've looked in every room. I don't know. There's probably some random surface I didn't look on that has the fucking mansion key. It's in the courtyard. You should find Professor Barton slumped against a tree. He's not slumped against a tree. If you've already been to the basement and received the mansion key, he'll be hanging. I haven't been to the basement. What the fuck? Where is the basement? What is this? Did I miss it? This is fucked up. I actually don't know what it wants me to do right now. Get the candle. Use the stair key on the keyhole. Okay. Okay. Yeah, okay. Get the library key. I did that. Chat, I don't know what I did wrong, but apparently I was supposed to have this key already, but I don't. Are you cheating? I am cheating, because I'm completely fucking lost right now. Key is in the eye of the beholder. Mansion key is in the kitchen. I'll check it. That should be right through here, and then through the wooden door. Well, they're all wooden doors, but through the lighter wooden door, I guess. This thing. What about the Womansion key? Ah, shit. Someone got too high to play the game. Dude! Man, this is, you're looking at the worst parts of this game right now, where it's just like, ah, well, random bullshit prevented you from continuing the game. You didn't look at this thing randomly that is not obviously a key. To the pantry? Oh. Like, I can appreciate that they, like, mix things up between scenarios, like, when you're playing as Helen, it's, like, stuff is in different places. That's fucking hilarious, thank you. Indeed, that's why I read it out loud. Inspect the shelf floor, then shelf again. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. That's some garbage, man. Exclamation point. There's something back there that looks like a switch. Better go look at this next, I guess. The floorboards are loose. Ta-da! Alright, this is the basement, I guess. Even though it said if you don't go to the basement first, he should be slumped against a tree and give you a key. It rhymes, so it has to be true, right? Alright, let's pick up these Donkey Konga controllers over here. Barrels of wine, something smells sour. I guess it's because I walked into this room. Like, not this room, but the room above, so it's like, ah, well, you've been to the basement, clearly. This guy's already dead. Wine bottles are covered with cobwebs. Oh, you just leave. You don't need to do anything. Wait, shelf, then floor? Hold on. Where is the floor? And also, which shelf? I think we could just leave, probably. Find the key, you must find the riddles 3! Wine bottles covered in cobwebs. Yeah, this is like, this is the worst part of any like, I'm not even calling this game out, but any, like, point and click. I'm pixel hunting right now, because I had to fucking combine the broom bristles and the gum to make a fake mustache to impersonate this guy whose ID doesn't even have a fucking mustache on it. I don't know what game that is, but that's from a real point-and-click game that's, like, the worst. Something just made a noise. Okay, I think the guy is slumped against a tree now. Yep, had to fucking open the hidden passage to the wine cellar to make that guy who fucking was hung from a tree fall down so I can get the key out of his pocket. Yeah, that makes totally perfect logical sense. It isn't complete bullshit at all. Like, fuck that. Actually, go fuck yourself, game developers. What is that? Oh, check the wine again after the noise. Oh my god. We're not even done yet. Round two. Talk to the wine twice? Yeah, exactly. That's like... Oh, man. I know this is a short game, but, like, come the fuck on. Exactly. Since I left the room, I might just actually need to go... Oh, here we go. Oh, look! I can actually... Well, oh, okay. Well, that happened. Kick him! Kick him! Kick him! Kick him! Keep kicking him! Got him! This will totally work, right? Oh, he's not after us now, somehow. I feel like he just baited me for memes, which is fair, I suppose. It didn't. It makes me more angry, honestly. Oh, this wine? Which wine am I meant to inspect? Because there's like 60 wine things in this room. Something smells sour. I'm doubting right now. I think because I left the room, I just was supposed to go to the other fucking room. And go find the guy dead against the tree. It's like they're trying to help me, like... have a backup in case I, like, fuck something up. But in reality, they're making it worse because there's just arbitrary conditions of, like, what the fuck do I actually do? Because, oh, you did this in this order? Wait, what? Seriously? I'm going to the other room. Fuck. I entirely trust your device, or your advice, but I feel like because I walked out of the room that maybe... I triggered the other scenario where this guy just has the key on him right now. Welcome to lagging sound effects room. Okay, no, that you're right. He's not on the ground. God damn it. Stop walking places, Jennifer. Oh, this game's driving me nuts. Why? There's like random... Oh my god, he's here now! Great! Oh, fucking good for you, asshole! Thanks! Doing great, sweaty. His voice tells me he's close to tilting. Like, this... I'm so fucking mad because this game is really good, but then there's just bullshit like this that's like fucking brain-dead, like, stupid. Like, it's like, oh... You get to check this fucking random wine case. Your auto-aim inspection shows you there's like two or three things in this room you can look at. But there's a secret fourth thing. If you look real closely, that's what you have to look at. If you do this specific order of things. It's so fucking bad. Like, that's so bad. Like, it's frustrating because the game's so good otherwise. Like, oh my god, man. Of course I'm tilted. Like, this good game is being ruined by dumb shit. Just shitty decisions at the, like, last minute. You know? It happens. It really does. I don't want to say this, but I gotta say it. This is the worst Clock Tower game I have played. I haven't played Ghosthead. We're playing that next. I'm sure that'll be the new worst one I've played once I play that. I have full confidence that the rumors are true, and that is actually a horrible game. But, Literally, I've never heard anyone say anything positive about that game. Will be without a doubt. Like, the SNES game had a couple things like that where it's just like, oh, well, shit, I have to do this random thing first to go in this spot. But I'm pretty sure I got, like, an ending where Jennifer survived. I don't know which one it was. I don't think I got, like, the best ending, but I got a good one without looking at a guide or anything, I'm pretty sure. Which fucking random wine bottle? Oh my god. It's the second barrel here. Something smells sour. No, okay, it's not that. Is it this one? That's so fucking stupid, man. That's so dumb. That's so dumb. A finger. Wearing Beth's ring. Beth, inside the barrel? Get fucked, Beth. Key laying in the pool of blood. You now have the mansion key. Well, guess I got a pixel hunt. Sometimes, I don't know. Beth would be behind the shelf if it wasn't Scissor Man. Ah, gotcha. I must have misread the guide, because I think it was... The way I read it, it was telling me that the professor, Barton, was, like, slumped against the tree. Oh, okay, she would have given the shed key. Or wait, she'd have given them. I misread your comment. Never mind. I'm thinking of SNES Clock Tower, a objectively better game. Not that this game's bad, but SNES game is better. Okay, so he's just sitting by the tree if he's alive. I gotcha. I am not. Oh, okay. I don't think I can go in here actually. It's no use. Metal fittings are completely rusted. Wait, no. We're getting in there. Rust? I got something for that. Oh, yeah. Aha! I knew it before chat said it. See, that is a reasonable puzzle. Rust, meat, oil. Let's go, baby. That's Scissorman in that chest over there, isn't it? I'm not opening this crypt because I assume no one's in it, and that fucking weirdo can die for all I care. This is still going to be the same thing, probably, right? Yep. The way this chest jiggled, I think Scissorman's in it, but whatever, man. Bats! Ah! Get out of here, bats! Reasonable puzzle solved by finding an item in this first scenario. Yeah, you know, you got a point. Stop! Stop it, bats! How do... I'm sorry. What? How do I stop that? I have no stamina now. That'll kill me if I do it again. Don't tell me I have to save that other fucking guy. You know what? I accept death. Bring it on. How am I not dead? I have zero stamina right now. They won't kill you. Okay, they're just bringing my stamina down. Gotcha. The item to solve this is in the room. Interesting. I don't want to save... Okay, bottom shelf, okay. A rope. I'll go and get another rope. Wonder why the rope and candle are together. You have the rope. What the fuck did you just say? Jennifer. Damn, I was hoping I would, like, comically fall out of the door. I, like, waited long enough. Alright, don't be Nolan in this chest, please. I don't want to save him. It's locked. What if I melt it open with a candle, though? How about that? Didn't work. Shockingly. second verse, same as the first verse. Ah, shit. Melt it open. Yeah, you know. I'm gonna oil it open. Hold up. Nah. Wait, it's locked. It's not. Don't mind me, chat. Alright. I don't want to save this guy, though. Maybe there's something else in this room that'll open the chest. Do I need to save Noland? Really? Fucking creeper. Ah, shit, he's coming. Ah, shit, it's happening, chat. Tripwire. Engaged. Dude, we're just playing pranks on this guy at this point. It's pretty great. I didn't get to see this animation before. He just tripped a little bit. I thought we were gonna drop the whole shelf of chemicals down on him. But no, he just trips. That's it. Okay. Alright, chat. Honest question. Is what I need to open that chest, is that in that room or do I need to go find something else? If you don't know, that's fine too. Use the cannon to kick him in the balls before leaving. I don't have cannonballs. That's Helen's scenario. I'm gonna go walk over here while chat responds. Imagine getting tripped while you're limping at the speed of 2 miles an hour. True. Also true. So I never gave a proper shout out to Maker. Pardon the pause here. Shit, is that an ant down here? It is an ant down here. What are ants doing down here? They shouldn't be down here. We have the library key, so we can get in here. But, oh, or it's just open. Oh, no, this is yeah, it's this room. Thanks again for the raid, bud. Hope your stream went well. I'm going to assume, I didn't check, but I'm going to assume you were crafting something. Crafting, that's a weird way to word that. Oh, I do have to talk to fucking Nolan. Damn it. I just want him to die, though. Is that okay? To unveil the mystery of ants, you must ask, that's what's in your pants. Excellent. Damn it. I don't want to save that guy. He's a fucking weirdo. He's asking 15-year-olds out on dates. It's not cool, man. Everyone else died in this chapter. Can't he die too? Probably shouldn't go near there. Okay, so this is still the same. I'm gonna go to the library first, then we'll talk to him. Wait. Is that just for more cannonballs? Because if it is, we don't even need those. We could just die and then find what it is. Trying to make an egg holder tray for organizing our many eggs? Dope. Yeah, go check out Maker. He does, like, cool shit. I was gonna say... oh, God, that's really bad. I was gonna say, like, me on occasion when I actually work on stuff on stream. But, no. He makes stuff. As his username implies. There are many books on the occult. I'm gonna trial and error this shit. Some writing carved in the desk. Take the dry path when choosing among the three. Wonder what this means. What does lighting this candle do for me? We're stumped at a raid and it never showed me on your stream, so I gotta figure that out. Oh, it showed up on my stream for what it's worth. You might have not been in the stream when it popped up. Candlestick holder. Wax has been dripped here and there. Is that not where the candle goes? Ah, shoot. Just to confirm, it did. It worked perfectly. Oh, shit. Hold on. I think I might know. Although, there's no box on Jennifer's scenario. Footstool. So maybe it's different. Because there was a candle there on Helen's scenario, which is why I thought maybe put the candle there. You fucking asshole. Hey, douchebag, how are you doing? Nutkick! Oh, she just shoves him. That's no fun. Oh yeah, I don't know. There's a weird finesse to it where, like, when you raid, there might be a little bit of a delay depending on how you join the stream. So you might have just not seen everything pulled out or unfold. I usually, like, click it the second I hit, like, raid now or whatever, but each their own. It's time to bedsheet this motherfucker. Got him. Fucking got him. Ba-bum. I'm glad I came back for this. As much as I've been swearing at this, like, particular chapter of this character's playthrough, like, there's so much shit I would have missed if I had just been like, oh, well, that's it. We got ending C for Helen. That's the end. Like, no. No, that's not the end. And there's still more we could do beyond all this, and I might someday, but I think we'll just... Whatever happens here, we'll count it as, like, done for now. Move on to Ghost Head. AKA The Struggle Within. Oh, there is the box up there. Why can't I see that? What the fuck? Wait, hold on. Give me that. I can't reach it. I feel like you've gotten deeper respect for Scissorman's efforts. Totally. Fuck yeah. Hey, what's up? Donegal. How you doing? An old lambskin parchment. The Barrow's family genealogy. What is this mark? Someone's been marked in red. Uh-oh. The 13th generation of the Barrows, Quentin Barrows. It says, traitor. You now have genealogy. Uh-oh. Okay. Fuck yeah, good. Alright, that symbol earlier had the sun on the top, right? Or was it the moon? Wait, shit, it was the moon. It was not the sun. Shaft keeps going. Wait, I want to do this wrong anyway, so I'm going to go down the sun one. It was moon, but I'm doing this intentionally so I can see the other ending. I can hear water at the bottom. Well, we're already fucking dead then, right? I can hear water. Crushed. Crushed to death. It's the moon, though. I know which way I'm going. Okay, so it's not the same where, like, there's cannonballs we drop down. We just go down whichever one the symbol was. The fuck was that mechanic in this castle? It was, oh god, what is his name? Trevor something. Is it Trevor Birkin? What the hell is the Resident Evil guy's name? I think that's his name, right? Where he makes all the, like, death traps in his mansion, then also eventually dies to one of them, essentially. No, wait. Trevor... Because it's Lisa Burke, right? So it would be Trevor... No. Is it? I don't fucking help. Help me, chat. Help. I can't remember these fucking character names. Moving walls is insanely crazy. It is. Looks like an altar. It made more sense in Japanese. I doubt that. Trevor Noah. That's wrong. It's Trevor something. Birkins. Because it's Annette Birkins, right? Fuck, dude. I should know this. Trevor Birkin. A dagger. Dagger with symbols called in it. Steven Trevor. No, that's... Oh, hey, zombie. What the fuck are you? I can't. It doesn't work. I'm dead. Dead. Dead guh. I probably need a different item for that. I'm guessing. This is cool, though. It's like a whole different area. Alright, don't take that yet. We probably need something else. I can just leave. There's no way. There's no way I just leave, right? You die? I'm gonna try it, but I don't think I can just leave. Yeah, I can't just leave. Or at least I don't think I can. I don't know. Maybe I have to right click it. I was left clicking for most of the time there. I'll give it one more try where I like click both things. I hit it too late. I clicked that shit immediately, but it's probably right click instead of left click. I was left clicking for a while and then like at the last second I tried to right click, so that's why I'm trying it again. George Trevor. I don't believe that either. Hold on. Yeah, I'm gonna fucking look this shit up. No, wait, no, you're right. Oh my god, because it's William Birkins. And then there's... then it is George. You're actually right. No, don't go back! Yeah, you're right. Sorry, I merged two different characters. Yeah, Ned is not related to him at all. Because he's like the retcon family, basically. Because it's Lisa Trevor, and it's, I forget the mom's name. But, yeah, no, you're right, it is George Trevor. Fuck. I just didn't trust Donegal, because I didn't expect him to actually look anything up. And there's no way he knew that off the top of his head. I guess there's like a 1% chance he knew that off the top of his head. I like merging characters. Mom Trevor. She does have a name, I just don't know what it is. Also, in my defense, as I always say, Resident Evil lore is Omega Lol. That's all you need to know about the lore of Resident Evil. No one remembers the mom. True. They remember that she exists, probably, because it's a large portion of, like, Lisa Trevor's plight, I guess. For a retcon family, it's a... Oh god, he's back. You know what, chat? We're gonna deal with him in the best possible way. Wait, no. This'll work this time, trust me. Trust me, this'll totally be okay. Oh no, we went through the wrong door! Go back out, it'll be okay. Remember the other time you didn't oh shit. What? I was tapping it! What the fuck was that? You didn't trust me when we put an address in the GPS that went 30 minutes out of our way? Who would ever use a physical GPS and not... Actually, I guess that was on my phone, wasn't it? Sure. Ah, is that... Ah, he's over there now. Damn, wait, I can do... I haven't used this one yet. We can do this. True. That is true, though. Ow! Says Jennifer. That was the least number of taps I've ever had to do on any of the action things in this game. It's like two clicks and I'm out of it. Alright, we have a dagger now. I don't know what I do with the dagger. Oh my god. I have the genealogy and a dagger now. That does not help me at all. Can I open this door with a dagger? Maybe? There is no way to open it. Great. I think we were locked out of a good ending, actually, because of that. I didn't grab the thing over there. Even though I went up the ladder, I don't know why it didn't work. It's fucking weird. I'm looking this up. What have I missed? Oh, the chest, right? I could open the chest probably somehow. Go down the hole, mansion key. Beth is not behind the racks, look in one of the barrels, find her dead body, you'll still find the key though. Ugh. Mm-hmm. Pick up the copper book, cool, we did that already. Storage room, get the box, wait. Wait, shit. Okay, hold on. Try going to the fireplace upstairs. I think Nolan just isn't in that coffin. I think Nolan's just fucking dead, which is great. Great news. Glad to see that fucking weirdo's dead. You were right all along, Purple Goita. Should have just looked in the goddamn coffin. Because apparently there's just a key in there. I'm gonna be really mad if he's the only other person that survives this, though. Like, everyone else has died, like, immediately. The fucking 28-year-old that's literally asking the 15-year-old character out on a date survives this. I'm gonna be heckin' mad. I must save before I do this. Scissorman is in there like you guessed. Oh, is he really? It says there's a thing in there. Oh, actually, oh wait, no, it doesn't. It just says there's the key, and then the key to open it's over there. That's a good point. Shit. Well then. Scissorman. Mummified Scissorman. The corpse looks very old. A key. Wait, how does she recognize that as a mummified Scissorman? What? I mean, sure he is, but there's not characters asking him out on a fucking date. Unlike our protagonist here, which is really fucking weird, man. That's all I'm saying. You know? Yeah, like how... Dude, yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, how is that a Scissorman? Helen! We saved Helen! Touchdown, baby. Look at what he's wearing. It's rotting corpse. That's what he's wearing. Helen, what are you doing in the box?
Are you alright?
Yes, but my...
She did dissect the Scissorman in high school biology.
Is there a way out of here?
I don't know. But I do know one thing.
We've always had bodies.
Don't kill Scissorman. He'll kill us whether we get out of here or not.
Cool. Great advice. Thanks. I think maybe we go down the Wait, I can't go down the fountain, can I? Because I didn't find a map.
Jennifer, there must be a way to destroy him in this mansion.
Jennifer is, in fact, the tallest character in this entire story, I'm pretty sure. And... Oh, Helen can translate the foreign note, but I don't have it, so it's like... Ah, shit.
I don't know.
Shit.
But I do know one thing.
Well, I think we're heading towards ending D then.
Don't
or C.
Superman. He'll kill us whether we get out of here or not.
Very good. Thank you, Helen. I'm going to try going back through the fireplace, but I think Helen won't be in here anymore.
Jennifer, there must be a way to destroy CD's
nuts.
Mansion. And I must find it.
Good for you. See ya. We did save right before opening her chest, so if somehow she's not here anymore, but we are able to go back through the fireplace, then at the very least I can go back and like reload from my save, go through the fireplace, get the foreign note, open her thing up, and then yeah. The classic. Hit him with the classic. Has anyone been so far as to... Oh, she stays in there unless Scissorman chases you. Okay. Well, I better fucking hurry, I guess. So this is the room with the fireplace that we came through. She wouldn't go back through it, but maybe she will now. I don't know, man. That really fucking sucks if it's just like, what? If you gotta find it or else. It smells like something's burning. That's Tim. Tim's dead, I think. Or Nolan, ideally, but I think that's Tim. Camera on the floor. Professional camera Tim was using. ... Ah, it is Tim. Rip Tim. F indeed. Oh no, Tim! Coming through, bud. Oh no, Tim! Can I get around him? Bye, bud. Luxurious fireplace. Inside is a passage to the chapel. So fucking go in there! Why? Why can I not go back? Tim is easily the hardest to keep alive. I have no idea how I keep any of these people alive, honestly. Front's all scratched up. Maybe I put the dagger through this? I don't fucking know. Maybe we put a candle on Tim to... It's about timing. That makes sense. But... I think the, like, SNES one... Like, I will say this for this game's credit. Like, I think the SNES one is, like, a lot of it is RNG of, like, who survives. Which can probably be pretty frustrating if you're trying to get, like, the best ending where, like, the most people survive. Or at least the most people don't die is probably a better way to word it. Because, like, I think it enacts... It's, like, Jennifer and her, like, one of the other people, like, are at the end cutscene in the best ending. Oh, okay. Open the door to the left. Wait. Talk to Nolan. Wait, what am I doing now? Go through the door in front of you on the balcony. Okay, so left is... Oh, maybe left relative to the character. I might be screwed, but I'm just trying to fucking end the game. Like, this is what pisses me off so much. I'm just trying to fucking find the end here. Like, I know I'm screwed because it won't let me back to get the fucking foreign text or whatever. I don't know why I didn't find it in the first place. It's kind of fucking stupid. Some matches on the floor. You now have the matches. Cool. But, yeah. Ever use your Witcher senses to find the next clue? Good meme. So I think I gotta go out to the balcony and attempt to open the door to the bone room, and then Scissorman will bust out of it. Is it this door or the other one? I think it's the other one, actually. Like, we're probably screwed as far as ending A, B, or D goes, but that's okay. I don't even care anymore. I just want to fucking finish this game, man. Why every fucking time? Like, this chapter is so... Like, it's such a good setup, but it's such a, like, infuriating, like, actual thing to play. It's so... Oh, man. And then use the cliff. Gotcha. Yeah. Oh, wait, is that what the cliff is for? Evading him out here? That makes a lot of sense, actually. So it says the door to your left, but it means, like, the door to Jennifer's left, not, like, the door to the left of the level, which would make way more sense, which is just more so, like, this guide writer's problem. But, you know. Mate? Hello? Go in the window. What are you doing?
Jennifer.
Oh, and give me a gun, just like Gots did.
You're alive! Where is everyone?
I don't know. Scissorman attacked us, and everyone scattered. Oh.
Nolan, you've hurt your leg.
Just a cut. I'll be all right if I rest.
Nolan, I'll go.
By yourself?
Stab him! Stab!
Stab! I'll come back after I've found and killed him.
Use a takedown. Just remember my CQC. TKO the ghost.
What was that?
You saw them too? I've seen them a few times already.
Because I've been sitting here for like 2 hours.
Of the children killed here.
So many.
Alright. Presumably he's dead. No need to check any further. Bones are all over the floor. Cool. Very cool. My brother, they were grinning and singing choir music. So I'm just out here now. What does that fucking do for me? He didn't give me anything. Some magical event has opened up now. That is called the Crypt of Sorrow, by the way. Which you'll get after unlocking question... Go left... Wait. Alright, you know what, chat? This game never fucking ends. I gotta piss. I'll be back again. Blame myself for drinking so much water and staying properly hydrated. I'll be back in a minute. Read his codec entry. Finish this. Oh my god. I'm just reading the guide at this point. I'm so fucking like done with this. Okay, ignore the creepy camera angle, blah 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 blah. Yeah, use the stepladder, get the genealogy. It mentions Quentin, that he's a traitor. Go through the door, blah 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 blah. First floor. Go through the door at the back left room underneath the master bedroom. Underneath the master bedroom? What the fuck? The sitting room. Okay. Oh, find Quentin in... Okay. Alright. I think I know what to do from now. Dude, the clues in this game are... The clues in Jennifer's scenario, version of the scenario are dog shit. This is, like... Some of the worst fucking point-and-click logic I've ever fucking seen. Oh, this random genealogy thing you picked up mentions that Quentin's a traitor. You have to go find Quentin on the wall over here. Then you find the map to go drain the fucking lake, I guess. Plaque reads Quentin Barrows. He's the 13th generation. A note is stuck to the back of the side of the portrait. It's hard to read, but it says, danger is near. I've hidden the map in the library. Hope people in a later time may discover the door and expel the devil children from this world. Quentin Barrows. Apparently you haven't seen much point-and-click logic. Oh, I have. I have indeed. Use your Prima guide. That's essentially what I'm doing, because this is so fucking stupid. Oh, man. They've fucking face-planted in the last act of this fucking... other character. I'm mad. I'm so mad. I'm mad because this was so good. Until, like, now. Like, it's like, oh, you gotta look at this random, like, specific point on this wine barrel that's between, like, very precisely between two other areas that it clicks to, like, the area of. Like, oh, after this thing happens, then randomly you can go here. Favorite point-and-click game? Probably Day of the Tentacle, if I had to pick one. Solid game. It's funny. It's fun. Yeah, unless... No one would count this as a point-and-click game. I was gonna say Song of Horror if you count that, but that's not a point-and-click game at all. I don't know why I even, like, thought about that in the same breath as that game. Dot is a good call there. Thanks. I pressed escape like it was going to open a map. We're just going to the library. This is not the library, by the way. What the fuck am I doing? Still gotta try that one. Think I have a choice for it. I haven't played Grim Fandango or Full Throttle, but I have played a lot of other Tim Schafer games. Tim Schafer, gotta be one of my favorite people with a hilarious anagram hidden in their name. But we're not going to talk about that. Because he doesn't like it. Books on alchemy. I assume there's something in here somewhere. No, that's the door out of here, I'm pretty sure. Say it, coward. Just go Google it. You can find it pretty easily. Philosophy books. The second I say Tim Schafer and anagram, most people probably already know what it is anyways. That's fine. There's nothing here I can she can't read, chat. She can't fucking read. They're on books on alchemy. There are many different languages. By the way, mad respect to Tim Schafer in general. I think it's just very funny that both he has a very funny anagram in his name, and also he's very angry about it when he seems to otherwise be a, like, super chill, well-spirited dude. Met Tim Schafer at the Double Fine party at PAX. We actually, like, have random, like, connections into Double Fine. Not Tim Schafer, but other people there. So I hesitate to, like, not that I would be critical of them, because I do like what they put out, like, just overall. But you know. Not that they'll ever find out about it anyway, you know? I love the Netherhood. That's one I haven't played yet. Ah, shit. Fuckboys here. One day I want to play all their games. I haven't played Broken Age either, but... Oh, he's right behind me, okay. I think I have most of them, actually. In one form or another. I like the Monkey Island games, too. They're quite fun. But... Oh yeah, you've mentioned that before. Wait, is the Netherhood not part of, like, Double Fine somewhere? But that is, like, a game that I've... at some point wanted to try out, you know? Regardless of, Oh, I don't know if I have enough stamina to get up. Oh shit, we might die here. Get up! Get up, Jennifer! We made it. Huzzah. Wait, we're at full stamina. No, we're not at full stamina. Okay, I am actually lost. I thought the clue was, like, leading me back to the library, but there's nothing there. Unless that's telling me to go to get the dagger, and I've already done it, so maybe that's the problem. Second floor sitting room. Chances are something burning, someone's dead. It happens. Check out the fireplace, find the body, pick up the matches on the floor. If Tim's alive, talk to him, he gives you the matches. Okay. Library corridor. Okay. The study. Wait. Look at the fireplace. It's too dark to see. Use your... Oh my god. Okay, here we go. So we have to go to the dark fireplace and then light the match, light our candle over it to find it. Okay, so it was LucasArts and DreamWorks. Gotcha. My bad. It was on my right, like, you know, it's all kind of mishmashed. Like, those things aren't like a separate Venn diagram, you know? Like a lot of Tim Schafer's earlier works was under LucasArts, so that's why I was like, you know, it's on my radar. In people mention it a lot in the same breath, I suppose. Wait, I probably want to use mat candle, then match, right? I can't see anything. It's too dark. Candle. Well, there you go, chat. That's... That's the death you get if you inspect one of the dark spots twice in a row. I'm the one thing that I do enjoy, like, this is a good, like, I don't know if pacifier is the right word, but like it's a consolation prize, I'll put it that way, of like when you don't know where you're going, you at least either get a hilarious death out of your character, or you get a cool ass like action animation against Scissor Man. Candle's been placed in the holder. I get it now, chat. I understand. Something's stuck in the back. This looks like a sketch of the mansion. Seems to be a passage drawn on the fountain. You now have the mansion map. Yeah, we were like uber screwed, by the way, but that's okay. These puzzles are very basic. I played Machinarium. Was a fun game. That reminds me a lot. This is like a long shot here, but there's a bunch of Flash games, a series of Flash games rather, that I played a long, long time ago called, was it Subsystem? Subworks? Sub something? I've also played Somerost. There was like five of them. They were all Flash games. Oh, my cursor's fucked up again. What is that game called? What are those games called? Submachine. No one said that in chat. I figured it out before anyone said it. Just for the record. Not that anyone cares. But is that a door at the bottom? Those games were super cool. This might be the valve to drain the fountain. Yeah, we're about to get fucking hit in the back of the head with a rock and get the shitty ending, by the way, chat. Even though we got all this shit. Oh well. Too bad, so sad, whatever. I'm not going back at this point. It's 1 a.m. I gotta wrap things up here. Like I said, one day I may go chase the other endings I haven't gotten here, but, what a fucking piece of shit this game is that you can't go back through the fountain, or the fireplace, I mean. Like, in Helen's ending, you can't, like, fix ending A once Jennifer dies, which is fine. But, like, you can still get, like, ending B or C. Kind of want to stream Deadly Tide? Do it. Yeah, Professor's here. He's going to fuck me. Pardon my poor choice of words. That's not what I meant. He's not actually here. Something's gonna just, like, insta-kill me, probably, though, right? We don't have the incantation to, like... Yeah, here we go. I see you hiding over there. Jennifer. Huh? Fucker.
That voice.
Who are you? Oh, it's Kay. She's gonna fucking... What? It was in my face this time. Well, GG's.
This is the place where many mangled male and female bodies are being found.
The search for male and female bodies? Oh my god.
Hey, someone is still alive. Carry them gently.
It's the Scissor Man. There seems to be. Please pull your scissors out. Oh, it's just him. That's a better... Okay, that is a better ending than Helen getting... What is going on? I literally have no hands on my keyboard, and it's just like, skip the fucking credits. Fuck you. Survivor unidentified. Anyway, We're done with this game for now. I will now torture myself with Demon Head. Or, not Demon Head, Ghost Head. A.K.A. Clock Tower 2, The Struggle Within. A.K.A. the third Clock Tower game they made. Because Lamau. Nice. Hell yeah. Enjoy that sharing. You're no fun. I didn't try to skip the credits unless you mean, like, go back. You want me to go replay 2 hours of gameplay to go get the other ending because I didn't fucking click on the thing at the right time? Like, that's bullshit. Jennifer's ending is bullshit. Her whole scenario 3 is a fucking pile of shit. I hate that. I hate that so much. Helen's makes so much more sense. Yes. Good. Oh wait, maybe Pamphlet lets us see our hints. Oh, there's our hints. Let's look. Let's read the hints. Oh, we've gotten almost all the hints. We've only missed 2. The main character is determined by the number of times Harris is spoken to in the corridor during the prologue. Well, that's... He has spoken it 2 or more times, then Jennifer becomes the main character. By the way, you need to get past the prologue to get this hint. What the fuck? What fucking crack were they smoking? They're like, yeah, this is how you select your character, and also, I guess we gotta let the player know somehow, so play through the game, then this hint that opens up in a menu that you may or may not have noticed, which I just noticed this now. What the fuck? If that was in the pause menu, I'd feel slightly better about it. Because the second I found it, the first hint, I was like, oh, let me go pause and figure out how to try to read this hint I just found. Nope, you gotta go back to the main fucking menu. Those are hints, true. Hint 2. If a certain item is not picked up in scenario 1, then the best ending will not occur. That's the flashlight for Helen, it's the oil for Jennifer. We got them both, still didn't get the best ending for either of those fucking characters. When in a pinch... There are many times when clicking on some item will rescue the character. That's a super useful hint. I'm okay with that being in a screen like this. Actually, hint 2 also, same. Like, you know, that's just trying to guide you towards the best ending. That's fine. But, like, where you don't even know how the fucking character select works because of some obtuse bullshit? Fuck that. This was pretty alright back in the day. Now this is just garbage. Maybe so. Okay. I'm so angry not because this game is garbage. Like, I'm angry because this game is, like, 90% good and then there's, like, 10% that's just, like, a fucking, outhouse being, like, deposited onto your fucking front lawn. Like, that's my review of this game. It's, like, pretty much really cool, and then there's just, like, a sharp decline in, like, certain spots where it's just fucking annoying as hell. This hint system? Yeah, okay, that's fair. This does not translate well. If you could read these the second you pick them up, it would be a different story. But some of these things are very specific. Like, this would just tell you, like, oh, go fucking pick up an item in scenario 1 or else... don't give up. Try to click on something until the very end. In current day, this would just be a tutorial you go through, basically. And then some of the things would be ambiguated so you don't, like, know exactly what to do, I guess. One extremely important point is... Who is asked to investigate the statue in the prologue. We got this, like, in the second scenario, I'm pretty sure. So let's... Do not forget who was asked. So it's already too late at that point, which is fine. That's totally fine. Helen is the protagonist in the last scenario. Be very careful of the item she is given by Harris. If she uses it... ... What hell does Harris give her? Oh, that's the furnace key. This would be considered frustrating now, wouldn't you say, Goon? Gee, I wonder if my actions and words speak for themselves. This would be considered frustrating with the way these hints are laid out. One point to Ghost Head, they let you read the hints upon picking them up. That's what I'm talking about. This game, okay, also, to be fair, this game was made in 1997. This is before Resident Evil 2 came out, the original one. So, like, you know... I gotta give props to this game where it's due. Like, this is a good game, all things considered. It's just, there's some things that are very frustrating about the game. And I think I've made my points abundantly clear, so I'll stop ranting now. Let's read the rest of the hints. Helen is the protagonist in the last scenario. Something must be dropped down the shaft when deciding which of the 3 shafts is correct. That's a useless hint, because you could just fucking brute force that, honestly. I mean, it's not useless, but it's you don't really need it. If Jennifer is the protagonist in the last scenario, when she is trying to escape and runs out onto the second floor terrace, if you click on dot dot dot, also quite useful. Luckily we have guides in the modern day that I can just read. When carrying the box that cannot be opened, you need to do something fairly drastic to get at the contents. That's so unnecessary. Like, that one's super easy to fucking figure out. That's all I gotta say. Alright, chat. Clock Tower Story, question marks, is the last. In the mountains of Ramsarden, Norway, stands the Barrows family mansion. The mansion had a large clock tower by which locals tended to their flocks in the surrounding fields. The local people called the mansion the Clock Tower. In 1986, the mistress of the Barrows... we already know this shit, but whatever. The mistress of the Barrows Manors gave birth to twins. From that day, they were born. From the day they were born, however, it was obvious the twins were not normal and were evil. Okay. The twins were given the names Bobby and Dan, who were later to become the murderous Scissormen. Oh, I forgot about Bobby Scissormen. I only remember Dan Scissormen. In 1995... It's only for the Americans and newbies to... Yeah, that's fair. That's fair. Don't get me wrong. I don't hate... Like, this recap is great. Even if you were in Japan, you played the first one on Super Nintendo or the PS1 version of it. Like, it's... You know? Oh, sorry. If you were in Japan and had the chance to play either version of the SNES one or the PS1 version of one... it's still useful to have this available if you hadn't played it. Like, maybe you were just like, hey, I want to play this game. I guess you probably wouldn't pick up a game called Clock Tower 2 without playing Clock Tower 1. Or maybe you would, I don't know. But definitely useful for the US since you hadn't played it. Yeah, or you just forgot. Maybe you played it a while ago, even though these games were like a year apart in release, I'm pretty sure. So, you know, it's unlikely, but it's not impossible. Maybe you picked this game up several years later, like, oh, I remember playing Clock Tower 1 20 years ago. Like, a couple of years ago, I'll get this one, the sequel. I don't want to buy Clock Tower 3 yet, I don't have a PS2. That's wrong. Because Clock Tower... No, that's right, Clock Tower 3 is universally Clock Tower 3 across everywhere. But maybe you're, like, thinking a couple years down the road, oh, I heard Ghost Head's awful, I don't have a PS2, so I can't buy Clock Tower 3 yet. I haven't checked out Clock Tower 2 anyway. Let's go play that. But it's been a while since I played the first one. Sorry, I'm like assaulting everyone's ears with this loud-ass music right now. I'm just peeved we never got First Fear properly. Yeah, that's entirely fair to say. Having not played it, but, you know. I understand the situation and totally get the annoyance overall. Alright, you're jamming. Cool. In 1995, a young girl from the Grandin Orphanage, whose parents died when she was quite small, was lured into the Barrows Mansion, where she was attacked by a monster wielding a giant pair of scissors. The monster was the grown-up Bobby. She managed to escape from the terrible horrors, destroy the monster, and flee the mansion. For the next year, all of Norway was caught up with the sensational Scissormen murder. Although Jennifer thought he was dead, Scissormen has reappeared. Again, really, story-wise, really cool setup to a sequel. Both these games, you know, the first Clock Tower and this one, they feel like a horror movie, which is really cool. 3 is a whole other thing. I love 3. 3 is still my favorite out of the three of them I've played so far. It probably will remain my favorite, even after we finish Haunting Ground, but we'll see. I will try to remain unbiased as I play the other ones. I can't imagine that the next one that we play is going to take that place, because apparently everyone fucking hates that game. Never heard a single person defend that game at all. But we're going to play it anyway, just so I can say I've played the whole goddamn series. yeah. But yeah, that is GG's on this game. I am not against playing this game again to get the other endings. I would love to see ending A for Helen and ending A for Jennifer. And hell, even these other endings for Jennifer. Ending E is probably, like, that's short-ish to knock out, because you just go to the wrong place and then do that chapter. You know. But, for now, though, I'm gonna get going. Because it is quite late, I have work in the morning, etc., etc. Hopefully, the contractors will be done with my bathroom tomorrow, and I can use it. They're pretty close! For the record, tiling's all done. The walls are up, but they haven't been painted. And then they gotta go put everything else back in, like the, you know, the vanity, the mirror, the toilet, etc.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really
don't work,
fine.
You just can't if only. Get
into it because they would never understand.
And then also, oh yeah, I guess my shower head's not installed, but that's okay. I'm hoping they did the tiling in a way where the grout will set and I don't need to like worry about like not showering for a couple days past them being done, but we'll see. All questions that will be answered tomorrow. Poke holes in plastic cup to make the, just turn the, no, they ripped everything out. I mean, I guess the pipe is still there, but like, it's not like I could turn any knobs to like turn it back on. But yeah, that is it for Clock Tower 1 for reals this time. Next stream, actually, so definitely no stream tomorrow because I have somewhere to go on Saturday early in the morning. I'm not going to say no to necessarily to a Saturday stream, but I wouldn't say count on it. Sunday we'll be doing more game dev stuff, be working on my Bomberman clone. I got to find a better, I guess I have a name for it, it's Goon's Blast, but if anyone wants to know, it's like MacGyver that shit with a garden hose. And then we'll start Clock Tower 2 or Clock Tower Ghost Head or Clock Tower 2 The Evil Within, whatever fucking name you know the game by. We'll start that shit on Tuesday. At some point I also want to come back to the N64 stuff, and we're gonna play the next game, which is Win Back Covert Operation, which is apparently a really good game. Goon's Blast sounds raunchy. Eh, maybe. It's just a chill, fun party game that has online play. That's all it is. You know what it is. Why am I explaining this to you? But yeah, thanks so much for joining me, everybody. It has been a blast. Thanks again for the raid, Maker on the Move. Goon's got a blast. And yeah. See y'all later. Take care. Have a good one.